watching Alfred do post game because I just want to see his reaction to this fight because he's gonna lose it a million times.
Fun.
Everyone in chat that is not saying mommy, mommy to Cynthia's great grandmother is telling him to get over
it. I don't appreciate the fact that you spoiled that.
What, you didn't expect her to be in the game?
I didn't expect Cynthia's grandmother to be in the game. No, I didn't.
You don't know what she looks like.
I thought Volo was going to be the only ancestor of Cynthia. But if it's not confirmed that character, whoever that may be, is related to Volo, then they can't both be related to Cynthia.
They could have, you know.
Yeah, but why would they both... They wouldn't both look like her then.
What?
I'm so confused.
I don't think you know.
The loading icon in this game is so cool. All right, I changed my drip up. W. I got a W fit on right now. Yeah, I have some wing balls now. We did get to craft those for the first time. Wait, why can I waste Pokeballs? Why can I waste those items? That's so dumb. I need to organize my inventory. So I'm going to go over to the crafting man because he lets me access my item box. Alright, if we give that one guy three of these pop pods, we get more stuff available at the merchant, I believe. Those are important. Those are kind of important, I think. I don't know. That I shouldn't have in here. Alright, let's see. What do I have that's craftable? We can make smoke bombs. We can make some... Oh, we can make a singular super potion. And we can make 11 hyper potions. Yeah. Let's do it. Actually, wait. I have 10 revives on me. We'll only make a few of these then. I'll make 4. Pokeballs, we can make whatever. We need more Sky Tumblestone, though. We are out of Sky Tumblestone. Is that as organized as we're going to get the satchel? Because we have a pretty full inventory, if that is the case. Oof. Yeah, we might have to buy some inventory upgrades while we're at it from my boy, whatever that guy's name was. We'll figure out what his name was right now. Let's watch. Yeah. Okay. This fucker. Bagging these nuts. Oh wait, new requests. Let's do that first. Wurmples evolved. Oh. Interesting. So maybe Bugene is gonna evolve into a Dustox instead of a Beautyfly. That would be funny. A nose pass to guide the way.
I think it's stars that make it evolve, but it's not 6 stars, because I'm 6 stars.
I just got a request about it, though. The Seas Legend? The sighting of a mysterious Pokemon. Interesting. Wonder what that mysterious Pokemon may be. Oh, hello, Laventon. Why are you talking to me? Jolly good choice there, Daniel. I see you've taken on that request I posted. Oh, it's posted by the professor. Let me fill you in right away, then. I was strolling alongside Prelude Beach the other day when I saw something swimming a little way out from the shore. Rather regrettably, it disappeared before I could snap a picture, but I can only assume this. But I can only assume this mysterious swimmer was some sort of Pokemon. From the way it swam, it seemed to be drifting on the ocean currents. Now, if I'm not mistaken, from the seas behind Jubilife, that would take it all the way to the Cobalt Coastlands. Dang it! Oh, I thought I was just gonna have to go to Prelude Beach. Now I have to go to a place and actually adventure. That's cringe. Although the Cobalt Coastlands is probably one of the coolest looking places. This rather leaves me wondering if the Pokemon was headed there for some specific purpose. Given the circumstances, I was thinking that if we spoke with the good Warden Iskin of the Diamond Clan, we might learn more. So I have to speak to Iskin.
I'm coming, hold on.
Oh, he's here. Interesting. I got your message, Professor. So, you're looking for a Pokemon that was swimming towards the Cobalt Coastlands, yes? Well, I'm very sorry, but I can't tell you much based on that alone. But, well, there is one thing I can tell you. I've heard that long ago in the Cobalt Coastlands, known as the EC, a princely Pokemon was said to live in the waters there. The story of this princely Pokemon can be found in a tome called The Sea's Legend. But no one knows much about it, about either the tome or its tale, beyond what I've just told you. So, that's all I know. I guess I wasn't much help after all. Sorry about that. I'll just take my leave here then. Damn, Iskin. Cringe move, not gonna lie. Alright, I'm gonna talk to Bugene, but first I'm gonna go do this request over here so we can get more stuff at the shop. Shit gets sticky like mud. Alright, let's see. If it isn't the Survey Corps recruit who quelled the Lady of the Ridge, what can I do for you? Running errands for Choi again? Sending a customer to negotiate for him once was bad enough, but twice? Where's his spine? Pestering me for goods, I'm already tearing my hair out trying to get Pop Pods. Sheesh. Wait, you've got Pop Pods? Would you let me have some? Please, just three. Sure. Ah, Pop Pods, the Cobalt Coastland's finest feature. You'll often find these fine sea vegetables washed ashore. They're best known as a key ingredient in Scatterbangs, those lively items for scaring off Pokemon. Alright, I won't send you back to Troy a failure since you kindly brought me these Pop Pods. Tell him I'll set him up with some new wares. Nice. Okay, we're actually gonna check the new wares first, so then we don't blow all of our money on bagging the cash, Mister over here, inventory man. We don't want to blow all of our money on inventory space. So let's talk to Choi over here. We've got new goods in stock thanks to you. I know all this has caused you some bother. I do hope he and I can thaw things out at last, but thanks to you, we've got excellent new items in our shelves. Do buy some. New items added to the general store's offerings. Nice. Oh, it's my most valued customer. I was just hoping you'd come by. Need new goods again? Yes, it's the same business all over again. Taohua just refuses to supply any new goods to me. I suppose you must be wondering why he refuses any time I try to deal with him directly. Let's just say he has his reasons. Speak with him, would you? I'll imagine you have better luck if you bring him some crunchy salt as a gesture of goodwill. I do not have crunchy salt. But that is good to know. How many of these are there? Just getting new wares. What's this? A full heal. Oh, I've never made these. I didn't even buy the recipe for these. Used to heal any status condition. That honestly wouldn't have come in handy very many times. I don't know if that's even worth the money, to be honest. Stealth sprays. I haven't used any stealth sprays. The smoke bombs are actually more useful than I originally thought they would be. The bando I had is starving. Alright, we're actually gonna organize that satchel real quick. Oh yeah, we have a Goodra now. A very large Goodra. A very large Goodra. Hello. You gonna turn around? Oh! You're trying to kill me or something. Jesus. Okay, now we're going to talk to Baggin over here. And we'll also talk to Beauregard. Let's see, how much are you charging me? 7k? Sure. We can only afford one more, but that's fine. 8k? You're a fucking shill. Scammer. Alright, fuck off, you absolute dumb cunt. We're gonna be hitting the Alabaster Icelands for the first time after I check out what Beauregard has to say. I don't believe it. Professor Laventon seems to think that little Bugene here is a Cascoon. But, hello? It's clearly a Silcoon. And it says Cascoon. You're making some kind of Pokedex or something together with the professor, right? Then you gotta help me. Please go catch a wild Silcoon so I can prove it's the same species as Bugene here. I hate to break it to you, my guy. But I think you got the wrong guy. I like how its name is Bugene there. That's funny. Do I have a Silcoon? I don't believe so. Oh, I do. That's lucky. What else do I have here that's even of interest? We have that shiny Ponyta, that's cool. It seems to be it. Yeah, nothing else super interesting. Alright, well, let us give him this Silcoon. I actually had no idea that we actually had a Silcoon. Sorry, Beauregard. Just as I thought, they're exactly the same. Those eyes, though. Now that you mention it, I guess they're not exactly two peas in a pod. I just never would have thought two Pokemon this similar could actually be different species. Pokemon really are curious creatures, huh? So is it gonna evolve? I don't even remember. I don't know which one evolves into which. I'm assuming since he wanted it to be a Beautyfly, it's gonna be evolving into a Dustox. Yeah, Cascoon evolves into Dustox. I was right. Okay. Bugene, my buddy, I didn't know the first thing about you, did I? Sorry I hurt your feelings. You sure you're still happy to have a goof like me for your partner? Bugene, you lovable rascal. You are the only partner for me. This dynamic duo will stay together forever. A small EXP candy? Thanks. And at some point, you will evolve into a... something else. Yeah, you evolve into a Dustox. At least you should. Okay. I doubt this fit is going to be changing anytime soon, to be honest. Look at the drip. Respect it. You know what? Let's see if purple lenses look cool. Ooh, that does look really cool. Do I stick with my actual eye color? Or do I go with the one that matches the fit? I think I'll stick with my actual eye color. Although the purple does go very nicely. I like my character to look like me. Alright, let's get it. Alabaster Icelands. Yes, we are. Let's get it. I see. Of course, I'm all too aware of the injuries done to some of our own good people because of the frenzies of the other nobles. There seemed little choice but to intervene. Okay, just quick before we get into it, we are entering the, I think, final new area of the game, the Alabaster Icelands, and we're here to quell the final Lord Pokemon, which is Avalug, Hisuian Avalug. I'm very excited for this one because Hisuian Avalug is one of the new forms for the game that I'm the most excited for, because they made a very mediocre Pokemon look very cool with very, like, slight changes. They did not change it very much. But this Avalug out in the Alabaster Icelands hasn't harmed a soul, as I hear. And I guess I timed that debriefing pretty well. Does it really behoove us to go out of our way to subdue him? If Avalug is great and mighty as they say, he could very well cause avalanches. Avalug is normally very large, so this noble is allegedly going to be quite beefy, quite massive. Avalanches don't require any Pokemon's help. They occur perfectly well on their own, you know. I confess I still have my doubts whether we should even be getting involved in this case. No damage has been done so far, but if we send Daniel out there, we'll be putting him in danger of real harm. But if the Lord is suffering in its frenzy, like people say, then wouldn't it be kinder to quell it? There's simply so much we don't yet understand when it comes to the noble Pokemon. We don't know whether their frenzies truly are causing them to suffer, nor do we know why they enter these states in the first place, or if this is all connected somehow to the space-time rift. What is it, I wonder, that the commander hopes will come about from our quelling of the nobles? Or indeed, from surveying any of the Pokemon of this land, what is it he hopes to achieve? A way to coexist. I certainly hope so. The goal of my research is to help build a future where everyone gets along with Pokemon. Professor Lavender. Nothing to bother yourselves about. Doubtless I'm just being a silly sausage. Okay. You've got a mission to carry out, haven't you, Daniel? Then we will support you in it. The best support I can offer you now is another chance to practice your battle skills. Oh. Oh no, I have Gudra out first. I'm glad just to get the opportunity to battle you. The fact that I've been able to grow so much as a Survey Corps member and work together with Pikachu is due to you joining us. I have a Gudra that won't be listening to me. I mean, I guess you get to get some action. Oh, you are very large, Gudra. Very large. Yeah, I am gonna have to switch. I've just kind of had Gudra here just because I won't be able to use it until I go up another research level. Alright, you have a Mr. Mime. So ideally, we would go for a super effective move. And you are super effective and resist fairy. Could bring in Basque Legion to get him some levels. So, I think... You know what? I'm going to give myself a challenge. I hope it doesn't go for a psychic type move. It shouldn't.
Alfred beat it in one try.
Oh, you're just trash then.
No, he had a level 81 Sylveon.
Oh.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm fighting Akari. I bet he goes for a fairy type move. If he goes for a psychic type move, I'm sorry, Toxicroak. But if he goes for a fairy type move, which he probably will, then we're fine. I just literally can't battle with Gudra. Oh, I still get to move. I keep forgetting how this game works. Alright, we're just gonna do a regular poison jab. Okay, that did Oko. Good job, Toxicroak. Staravia. This might be a Toxicroak sweep. I tried really hard to not be too overleveled. If Pokemon in this game were just a little bit higher level, this would be such a harder game. I mean, I'm assuming the battle that you're doing right now is pretty fucking hard, but like, I haven't been underleveled for a battle yet. Go for a drain punch so you can actually get some health back. Oh, that O-code. Good job, Toxicroak. Easy wipe. I mean, all her team is level 46. My Toxicroak is tied for lowest on my team, and it's level 52. There's something so natural about the sight of you and your Pokemon fighting together. To be fair, she also had one fully evolved Pokemon. She had a Pikachu, a Staravia, and a Mr. Mime. Like, come on. You just gotta give her evolutions. I would like for the game to be harder. You could have just had, like, level 55 Pokemon and had a Staraptor, a Raichu, and a Mr. Mime. Good experience for Toxicroak. About your mission on the Icelands. Well, it will be a challenge, so be careful out there. As for me, I'll set off to the Alabaster Icelands forthwith. See you there, my boy. I'm hearing reports of one of those mass outbreaks out there. Stay safe, kids. It's a beauty fly outbreak. Is there always an outbreak? Are there some parts of the map that are just never going to be accessible? That's kind of annoying if that's the case. Looks like the outskirts of this island outside of Jubilife Village are not going to be accessible. And this little in-between with the river between the Alabaster Icelands and Jubilife Village isn't going to be accessible. And this little bit in between... I guess all the way in between Coronet Highlands, Crimson Mirelands, Cobalt Coastlands, and Alabaster Icelands. Do they all end in lands? Why? It's Jubilife Village, Obsidian Fieldlands, Crimson Mirelands, Cobalt Coastlands, Coronet Highlands, and Alabaster Icelands. Why do they all have to have lands? Oh, whoops, didn't mean to do that. Yep, we're going to the Snowfields camp. Let's get it. Can the outbreaks be Pokemon that get aggressive? Because that's surely going to be annoying as hell. Have you seen my new fit that I made at the end of last stream? MJ? This place is fresh. MJ, hello? Guess he's gone. This place looks sick, though. You look pretty nervous. My word, it's rather chilly here, isn't it? Glad to see you made it safe and sound in any case. Very few venture to these Alabaster Icelands, apart from Tao Hua leading the odd Supply Corps excursion to gather materials. But the Survey Corps, of course, must go anywhere that Pokemon are found. From what I gather, Ice Peak Arena, where you'll find Avalok, is rather far off, I'm afraid. Doubtless this mission to tackle Avalok will be another dangerous one. Learn all that you can from Arita and Adamant to try to keep yourself safe. Okay, I guess I'm meeting them. Oh, they're right here. Never mind. Daniel Brisk here, isn't it? How aren't you freezing? Freezing? I'm practically sweating. If you think this is bad, just wait. It's nothing compared to where we're headed. You know, I'm beginning to think the problem between us isn't a Diamond Clan thing or a Pearl Clan thing. It's just a you and me thing. Damn, rolled. We'll never see eye to eye on anything, will we? I don't see how we could, as long as you and your clan cling to your vision of an almighty Sinnoh that reigns over time. Forgive my bluntness, but if such a being even does exist, it's certainly not Almighty Sinnoh. Yes, yes, believe what you want. Just tell us where we have to go. Wow, look at that. Adamant is just an absolute based legend, and Arita's just twitter.com. We're headed to see my teacher, and he's only ever found in one place. So this teacher, I'm assuming, is the warden, which is? You're talking about that Garrick fellow, right? Where do we find him? It's at Avalug's legacy, obviously. Where else but a great mass of ice could I have meant when I said we'd be headed somewhere even colder? Where else indeed? Ready to go, Daniel? Yeah, let's do some adventuring. Let's do some Pokemon catching. Sure, stomp off without me. Shut up, Arita. You're not even cool. This is why I can't stand people who only care about whether time is passing them by. See you at Avalug's legacy, Daniel. Take care on your way. What even does that mean? What the hell is even that? I have a feeling Arcanine might be, like, really overpowered in an area full of ice types. A fire rock type. That sounds kind of unfair. To be brutally honest. What's that Pokemon over there? Snorunt. I can't go that way. That's just the exit. Okay, that does count as sneaking. That's good. Can I go up there? Oh, I doubt it. Doesn't look like there's anything to find up there. Apom? It's it's just an APOM. I mean, I guess we could catch it. We have a lot of spare feather balls. First catch of the day. I want this thing to turn around. I want it to be a good one. A nice first tryer. My sensitivity's kind of whack. Are you kidding me? What? What are you talking about? Okay, well, these things are so iffy on whether or not they, like, you know, work. Oh, is that crunchy salt over here? I need some of that for that mission. Can I go up here? Sneasler's actually really fun to ride on. Very easy. Look at that, I hardly even have to climb there. I'm just walking. Do I get to go all the way up to this peak? No way. That'd be sick. I doubt it, though. And if I can, there's probably not going to be anything interesting there. It's starting to get foggy. Yeah, there's going to be an invisible wall. Yeah, there it is. You cannot go any further. Alright, down we run. I like how it's just casually walking down like a 30-degree slope. I guess that would be a 60-degree slope, not a 30-degree slope. There's that APOM again. I guess I don't really care very much about APOM. I want to catch new things. But we can try again at this APOM. Oh my god, I'm very bad at this game. There we go. Let's go, we caught an APOM. Are these apricorns? Yes, okay, good to know. Alright, we want to get a snow run. A snow run is something we want. Now's our time to get one. Come on. Oh, come on, don't turn around. Come on. That should count, right? Ooh, that was close. I got lucky with that hitbox. That was a really bad throw. It didn't even get caught? What? Okay, they don't get angry enough for me to not be able to catch them. Okay, let's go. Okay, we caught it. That's nice. I will take it if we just catch it. This is looking like it's a job for Sneasler, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, there's just a cave. Just in there. Love Cleavor. Love me some Cleavor. Whoa, this is sick. This is actually so cool. Ooh, Bergmite. Seems to be a pretty large Bergmite. Oh, that one didn't work. Does it get mad? It does get mad. Good to know. Alright, we'll just get out of the way of this thing. We'll stop disturbing it. I'm just running through this off weird here because I kind of want to take it in. This place is sick, this little ice cave. Can you only find Bergmite? That'd be interesting. Caster ferns are completely useless in almost every sense. So we're not gonna try to grab any of those. This place is open as hell. Oh my god. What? Yo, let me get some mats, bro. A pile of swine and swine-ub? Oh, that's cool. Alright, pile of swine's probably gonna be pretty tough to catch, so we'll go for a wing ball. First catch with a wing ball. Oh! That thing was further away than I gave it credit for. What the hell? There's another ice cave? Oh, damn it. I'm wasting Pokeballs now. I'm such an idiot. What? That's sick. I want to catch a Swinub. I believe I could probably do that with a Feather Ball. Actually, I could probably get this thing with a Pokeball. Oh, unless my aim sucks. Come on. Nice. Easy swine up, easy swine up. Let's go. I'm just loaded with these new Pokemons. It's a Beniri, we already have Beniri. This is cool. A lot of old stuff though. Only really new thing that we're seeing are the snow runts and the Piloswines. And we did see those Bergmites too, but it's nothing crazy new. This is that ravine that I was just in. So I could climb up with Sneasler, or I could go through that cave and come to the left. That's nice. Multiple routes to get to the same place. Shake your sticky like mud. Any Migos fans in chat? Love me some Migos. Is this breakable? Oh, it is. Snowballs. Are those like another stunning item? They are. I'm not gonna keep those. I have too many. And new berries. Aspir berries. They cure. Frostbite. I need to start using berries and food more to start attracting Pokemon. I'm gonna start doing that. That's a half promise. Because I doubt I'm gonna keep it. I've used... Ooh, that's a Glalie. Okay. Let's see what Snowrunt likes and see if Glalie likes the same thing. Well, let's see what Pokemon, if they tend to like the same things as their evolutions. Because that would be nice. Okay, let's do Luxray, for example. Mushroom, grain, bean. And Luxio... Mushroom, grain, bean. Okay, so we should be able to look at what Snowrunt likes. And maybe that'll work. Oh, we haven't discovered nearly enough things to find out what foods they like. Okay, that's great. Okay, let's see. This attracts monstrous Pokemon and dragon Pokemon. Pokemon that dwell and wander among fields. Alright, we'll try a mushroom cake, I guess. Monstrous Pokemon? Is Glalie monstrous? Oh, I guess it is. Oh, I threw it. I keep forgetting that they can still just see you. Oh, that's an Alpha Glalie. I don't really want to do that. I'm not gonna lie. Hello, Alpha Glalie. Hello, non-Alpha Glalie. Backstrike? Oh, I should have used the Wing Ball. I wasn't paying attention. That's not going to get caught, is it? Ooh, almost wasted a Gigaton Ball. That would have sucked. It looks like a shiny Glalie because it's an alpha, but that is not a shiny Glalie. Alright, we're gonna have to ignore these Glalie for a moment, because I am a fool. Alright, let's see if we can try that again with that food again. They seem to like the mushroom cakes. Pay attention to the food. Look at the food. Look at the food! Look at the food! Why were you not looking at the food, man? What the hell? Yeah, I knew that wasn't gonna work. Worth a shot, though. Okay, let's see. This place is large. Oh my. Alright, I guess we could just adventure around then. We might not even get to Avalug today, I wouldn't be surprised. We're probably gonna spend hours just exploring. Which is the most fun thing to do in this game. This place is awesome. This place is huge. Damn it. Couldn't time it in time. That's annoying. It's Electabuzz? We already have Electabuzz. Alright, let's see. We need some Sky Tumblestone, that's for sure. We're gonna craft some more Wing Balls. Machoke. We do have Machoke. I know that for a factual. This is Arena's Approach. Yep, that's nowhere near where we need to be, which is honestly a good thing right now, because we don't want to be making progression right now. That's a sleeping Machoke. I guess I'll take advantage of the opportunity. Should be able to catch us in a regular heavy ball if we get a backstrike, which we will. Another cave. This is the third thing that this pattern has showed up on. It's Cresselia, Regigigas, something, what looks like an Arcanine, what looks like Giratina, something that looks like Darkrai, something that looks like Palkia. I don't know. Something that looks like Manaphy. This is all black ice, or is this supposed to be stone? Because this is giving off an ice type of vibe. It's a large Machoke. My. Not even an alpha. That's crazy. Whoa! That is cool. And there is a satchel in that direction. Oh, shit. Riolu. If that catches... Oh, that was funny. Just looked at me dead in the eye, and I threw a ball of lead in his mouth. That is hilarious. Alright, let's get this Sneasler. Let's see if we could get all the way up here. I bet we can. This hill's surely here for a reason. Yep, look at that. A Crobat. I don't believe we caught that Alpha Crobat when we had the chance, so I guess this is an opportunity worth taking advantage of. Oh, what the hell is its motion? It's very erratic. Ugh, so unpredictable. I don't want to waste too many of these because I don't have too many of these, but I might have to waste too many of these. I should probably get to a place where we're a tad closer to where we want to be. Okay, I guess we're too far away to farm that. That's fine. Oh, this is cool. What's that down there? Oh, it's just one of those king's leaves. That crafting material that I have yet to need at all. That I thought looked like it could be important, but seems to be quite the opposite. Can you only get snowballs from here? Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna break those then, because I really don't need these, nor do I want them. Oh, whoops. I wish you could discard things and they would drop down on the ground like stuff when your inventory is too full, because there are some things where you could like pick up a consumable. What's it called? You could like drop something to use a consumable that you just found. And then just pick the other thing back up instead of having to drop something just to use a consumable and then have an empty spot. Where you could have had something that you didn't really want so badly to get rid of. Oh my god, 100%ing this game is going to be crazy hard. This is going to take like at least 100 hours of playing. No way. I'll have this game 100%ed in like a year, maybe, if I'm lucky. Alright. See, is this a better angle on that crobat? I believe so. Actually above that little iceberg thing now, too. We're getting a bit of a fog, yeah. Okay, we're gonna have to hop down a little bit. Okay, now this could be a good angle for catching this thing. Oh, what? How's that fall damage, man? What do you mean? Okay. This looks actually pretty catchable, I'm not gonna lie. We gotta let it go through its weird movement cycle. That is way more confusing than just a circle. And then we can catch it. Ugh, so annoying. Okay, I don't know if this is a great idea, to be honest. That, oh, there's nothing? Really? Oh, come on. That's just a disappointment. You have that open valley of land and you're not going to let me go into it? That's kind of dumb. I will admit. I don't like criticizing this game too much, but that is just pretty fucking stupid. I'll say it as it is. That's stupid. Ooh, an Alpha Lucario. That's something that I would want to fight. Seems like a job for my boy, Spectre. So I'm gonna have my boy Spectre do the job. I'd rather the Lucario not be facing me, but Alpha Pokemon never cooperate when it comes to that. Nothing to see. Nothing to see, Lucario. Okay, nice. That took way faster than it usually does. Okay. It seems like strong style won't affect me super negatively, but agile style seems to be the play here. I have drain punch too. Alright, yeah. Agile style flamethrower. Let's see if we can get a burn. Burn would be huge. Oof, that did a lot. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Caught unaware, too stunned. Nice. Okay, so that was 60 times 1.5 is 90 times 2 is 180. So that was 180 total power, and it did about half. So we want to do like 150 power. So this stab becomes, let's see, 45 becomes about 70. This regularly becomes 90. So we do half of that, and that becomes a little over 100. Let's see. I could do that becomes 150. That becomes 180. That will kill. But if I do that, okay, this looks like the play. Drain punch seems to be the play. Oh! What? Damn it! I guess I should have just gone for an infernal parade. What did you master, Basky Legion? Ice Fang? I guess you. Oh, Shadow Ball, maybe? I don't know. Oh, that's so annoying. I mean, good job, but that's still so annoying. Alright. This could be useful for. I only really want to use these on Pokemon that I'm permanently going to be using, which are Pokemon that are not just permanent team members, but not going to be shiny hunted and replaced, which means Arcanine is going to be shiny hunted and replaced. I already know that. I know that Goodra, if the shiny's good, is going to be replaced. I need to see it in game, and it's looking like it probably will be. And Basky Legion, I'm getting the shiny. And I know for a fact, Toxicroak's being replaced in general, but it's probably going to be replaced by something that I'm going to shiny hunt, like a Zoroark or an Avalug. Not shiny hunting Typhlosion. Not shiny hunting Kleavor. And Typhlosion already, like, I don't need to give it physical defense. I probably should, but I don't need to. Kleavor is bulkier. Not by much, but I will give it its physical defense. Because its other stats haven't been worked on nearly as much as Spectre's have. Basically, Pokemon that I'm nicknaming are going to be ones that I'm going to be focusing on with experience and effort points. Because those are going to be part of the final team of Legends Arceus. Like, once I have the game beaten and everything, once I get all my shinies that I wanted and all that. I need to come back here and catch that Lucario, though. I'm very upset that Drain Punch unexpectedly killed. Guess I should have gone for an Agile Drain Punch. I'll know that next time, but next time I'll probably just go for a strong style Infernal Parade. That is why recently I've actually just been using Hatchet and Spectre for this. It doesn't give a lot of experience, but it adds up. So I've been giving the experience to the ones that need it more so than others. And not need it more so, that I want to give it to more so, the ones that are going to be final team members. So that's kind of how I'm gauging that. You know, I'm going to... Oof, didn't think I was going to take a fall there. I'm going to descend here and see what Pokemon I can get. Oh, I've been down here already. This is where the Riolu is. And then I climbed that really tall mountain. Ooh, jeez. Oh, I tried to call and sneeze learn. It didn't work. What the? Okay, well, that didn't work either. It's an Electabuzz. I'm just gonna... Ooh. Alpha Electabuzz is experience, but that's also an Elekid. We have not yet caught an Elekid. Fuck off, Riolu. Come on, Elekid. Turn around. Alright, let's try this first then, I guess. Oh, wait, nope. You bitch. Okay. Nice. Real new. Fuck off. Okay, we caught the Elekid, so that's cool. I want to see if I can just catch this Electabuzz just off. Like, what's it called? Just off rip. Because I know you some alpha Pokemon, you can actually just catch them. Or at least get them in the Pokeball. Not necessarily catch. This Rioldu just likes running in circles around me. Yeah, let's try it. Oh! Okay, I got it in the Pokeball. So that's something. To start. Obviously did not stay in the Pokeball, because it wasn't even a backstrike. I don't know why I'm in Sneasler right now, like it's actually doing something, but... regular-ass Ambipom. Okay, that's a new Pokemon. I saw one of these before, and I didn't go that direction. Snover. Oh, the Ambipom's not gonna fuck off. Okay, well. I guess we'll have to get it, too. What level are you? Level 48? Oh, the Electabuzz is here now, too. Fuck. Another grit item. Oof. Oh my god! And it parried? Oof. That's so unlucky. I would have been able to move again if the para didn't happen. That's unfortunate. Alright, we're just gonna run. I do have, like, 10 revives on me. So we're fine for now, but that is quite annoying. I'm just gonna give you a super potion. And ta-da, you're 1 HP from being at full. Oh my! That is going to hurt when I unpause this. Alright, we don't need this, so we're just gonna give you 1 HP with that. And Grit Gravel. This will help me get your special defense up, or your speed or attack up. Yeah, we'll give you some attack. Yeah, no way I was getting away from that. What is that? Was that from the Electabuzz that I was just fighting? I think it was. Diagro, please? Seems to have let it go. Ooh, that's an Abomasnow. Nice. Come on. Come on, Snover. Come on, Snover. Just turn around, man. Thank you. Guess I could have just used a Pokeball for that. That is an Abomasnow. That is quite a bit more intimidating. There's just a bunch of Hyloswines. Alright, I want to get this Abomasnow. I don't know how I can approach getting this Abomasnow, but I'll try.
I despise the entirety of...
The Abomasnow is on my ass. The entirety of what?
Oh, don't worry about it.
Oh. Okay. I guess I'll forget about it. In the bando, I had a starving.
Did you see the video I sent you?
I did not, because I'm streaming.
It was a while ago, though.
Oh, when?
I texted it to you.
What video? Just describe it.
Like 5 second clip from a video.
Describe it! I probably did watch it.
Cast on.
Oh, yes, I did watch that. That was very funny.
That was very very funny.
All right, come on, come on, come on. Let's go. Easy Obama Snow. Let's go. Is that an alpha Obama Snow, or is that just another Obama Snow? It's just another Obama Snow. What'd you say?
What did we catch?
I said, wow, easy Obama Snow.
What did you catch?
I caught an Obama Snow.
Okay.
Ooh, Blissey. Wild Blissey. That could be good experience. Hi, Snow Run. Why are you chasing me? Come on, easy catch. Come on, Blissey. Easy catch. Let's go. Wow, I didn't actually think that would work. Level 60 Blissey. Just caught it by hitting it with a wing ball to the back of the dome piece. That was nice. I believe I'm going in the opposite direction that I should be going. Don't really care. Oh, wow. I'm so used to not... Oh, okay. That didn't work. Space-time distortion. I'm gonna get on that. But first, I'm gonna use Ursaluna. I haven't used Ursaluna in actually a while. Alright, that's a Glalie. I failed to catch the first Glalie that I attempted. Ooh, wait, this one's asleep. Okay, I'm just gonna approach it from behind, crouching with a leaden ball, and that should be an easy capture. Nice! Alright, we caught a Glalie. Let's go. We no longer have to worry about Glalie in this area. That's good. Where's the space-time distortion forming? Ooh, in a place that I have not yet been to, so we're going to head in that direction. To that space-time distortion. Ooh, that is an alpha Piloswine. Oh, I've been running the wrong direction entirely. Alright, it's to my left. Okay. Oh, it's right here. I have found it. I need to test if you can use spoiled apricorns to stun aggressed Pokemon. Ugh. Gross. I'm diseased. Ooh, that is a Machamp. You could just turn around and give me a shot at this. Thank you. Very kind of you. Okay, didn't even shake. That's the second time I've seen that happen, where it just doesn't shake. The other time was with another alpha Pokemon that I did the same exact thing to. Alright, what are you weak to? You're weak to fairy, you're weak to flying, and you're weak to psychic. Fairy, flying, and psychic. I don't have any of those. well then. I mean, Spectre and Basky Legion are both immune to your stab. So I guess that's something. Bandolite is starving. I guess I could try to just lower you down and get you to be caught with a great ball, I guess. Yeah, we'll do that. Let's just bring Spectre in for this, I guess, because it's immune. Oop. Nope. Don't pay any mind to me. I'm doing nothing. I'm being silent. God damn it. Just missed, and it's just gonna go before me. It's level 70. I'm level 59. Oh, it didn't go before me. Let's go. Okay. I can go for an agile style move. I'll do an agile flamethrower. Let's go. We got the burn. That's huge. That's huge. Missed the stone edge. Oh, that is large. That is very large. Okay. Okay. So that was a 90 power flamethrower that we just used, and it did about a quarter. So it should take about 270 more power to kill you. Well, to about kill you. Infernal Parade, stab, this is about... What's half of 75? 32.5. It's about 108 power times 2 is 200. So this Infernal Parade is going to do a lot of damage. That would be 200 if I do a regular one. 90 plus stab is 130. That one is... 20 plus stab. Probably better off with just going for an agile one. Or honestly, just a regular standard Infernal Parade. Yeah, that was probably the call. Miss Stone Edge again? Okay, that is huge. That is very large. But that just happened. Okay, got the burn healed, which is annoying. I want to get to a point where an agile move will get us moved twice in a row. Doesn't look like that's going to happen, though. Okay, so I believe the only thing that's not going to kill here is an agile drain punch, so we're just going to go for that. A regular one might not have killed, but just to be safe. Okay, yeah, that was a good call. And it hit the stone edge. Right? That's going to kill. Yeah, good job, Spectre. Oh, it critted too. Damn. Ouch. Okay. And now I think Basculine
is
a good play.
I just released half of my Pokemon that were duplicates, and... just EV trained every one of my Pokemon.
Nice.
So hopefully I can beat this fight now.
Damn. Nothing. Stone Edge. We take one. Basky Legion is beefy. Beefy as hell.
The first shining I'm doing is Aura. After I beat it.
I don't know what my first one's gonna be.
I know Zoro appears in Outbreak, but I've gotten him like 3 times. Oh,
come on.
John video.
Ugh.
Methods?
I didn't want to because there was a section that said spoiler free, and then the rest of it wasn't, so I didn't watch it.
No, the whole thing is spoiler free.
Oh, the chapters, one of them said spoiler free, so I just didn't watch.
No, it's saying, like, chapter spoiler free. It's telling you that the entire video is spoiler free.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Can you just... give me a synopsis. Alright, I'm sending my Goodra. Goodra can munch on these things. It's sending out stone edges, and it's a Goodra. Great ball. Does it have something to do with outbreaks?
It's a bunch of different methods, and the best one is outbreaks, easily. It goes down to a 1 in 48. It's the maximum without charm. Or 1 in 48? 1 in 148.
I was gonna say.
Yeah,
oh my god, a close combat O-code? Jesus Christ.
What, Goodra?
Yeah. I mean, it's super effective. I guess it had the enragement boost, so I guess that makes sense. Just get in the ball, bro. Forehead.
Do alphas have increased stats?
Yes, yes. The fury boost that they have, like, it's been enraged with an X fury. That is a stat boost.
Base stats.
Yes. They the boss battle, not the Pokemon.
Oh.
At least I don't think so. And it killed itself with double edge. Everything has double edge. That's so annoying. Literally everything has double edge. Alright. I'm gonna use revives on you and you, and I'm just gonna level up Spectre, because I'm pretty sure leveling up revives them. It does. Spectre's level 60! It's my first level 60, let's go! Alright, we're gonna heal. 100 HP for you. That's most of your health. 100 HP for you, that's all of it. And 100 HP for you, that is also most of your health. And then Spectre, we're gonna use a Hyper Potion, and then a regular potion. There we go. Oh, what is this? Grit Dust. Okay, we're gonna drop something to use this Grit Dust. Oh, you know what? I need to start using berries just to heal negligible amounts of HP. Oh wait, these aren't even. These are status condition berries. I'm a fool. All right, Grit Dust, Spectre. I can use that on your physical defense, or I could use this on Hatchet's physical defense. I'm gonna just use it on Spectre's. Okay, is the space? Okay, the space-time distortion still has yet to form. That's a barrel. That's nothing interesting. How long do these things take to form? Surely it's gotta be like 10 minutes, right? Ooh, a little shining thing. You'll give me more than just snowballs then, I'm assuming. Stardust and snowballs. Oh, the distortion has appeared. We're gonna get rid of these snowballs. We're gonna get rid of these candy truffles. We're gonna get rid of these berries. And we're gonna use some of this stuff to craft some things. We're gonna get rid of this. We're gonna get rid of this. Nope, not favorite. Get rid of these. And we're gonna keep the crunchy salt, but we're gonna craft some things. How many? I have 7 revives. That should be fine. I think I'm fine with potions. And then if I run out of space, I can just turn all my super potions into hyper potions, which I don't need to do right now. I have, how much space is that? 9 slots open. That should be good enough. All right, we're gonna get Spectre on the ready. We're gonna start collecting these fucking shards. Let's get it. Ooh, what the? You're in the game? Why are you in the game?
What?
Scizor? That makes literally zero sense.
Yeah, I have a few scissors.
Why is it in the? That doesn't make any fucking sense. Did it just disappear? No, it didn't. I was gonna say. A Scizor? It's only level 50. Okay. I'm just gonna use an agile wave crash. Oh, oops. Yeah, it did a good chunk of damage. Iron Head did nothing. I could just use another wave crash. Seems like the life I need's a little distant. Alright, if Electabuzz doesn't go for, like, absolute dog shit. Okay, it went for Thunder Wave. That is actually very thankful for that. Oh, I got X-Scissor. Okay, that's resisted. That's resisted. X-Scissor's resisted. Okay. I'm gonna go for an Agile Rest. Oh, I got full Parrot. That's so unlucky. Okay, I'm so low. Okay, can I get off? Okay, I'm gonna pray. I'm gonna go for an Agile Rest. Okay, I got off the Agile Rest. Oh, it doesn't heal all the way. That's the Agile effect. Okay, that makes sense. Electabuzz used Thunderbolt. Does that kill? It does, damn. I guess the rest wasn't worth it. It's good to know that that's how that works, though. Seems to heal half if it's Agile style. That's pretty good still. Alright, so Bug-type moves, Steel-type moves, and Electric-type moves. Okay, you resist Bug and Steel. You resist Bug. You resist Bug. You resist Bug, Steel, and Electric. That's not surprising that Goodra resists all three of them. Yeah, we'll send Goodra in, I guess, for defense. That's Goodra's only purpose until I can actually have it attack. Bullet punch, munch. It's gonna do nothing. Okay. Items, great ball. Oh my god, you're level 50. Just get in the damn ball. Ooh, that thing has close combat. That's gonna hurt. Oof, almost killed. Jesus. Goodra's gonna have to go down in this fight, it seems. I'm not gonna revive it either, because it's not gonna be battling. That'd be a waste of a revive. Great ball. Oh, that's crit. And it caught. The one-hop, I'm telling you, man, it never misses. It's like J. Cole. It hit me with a thunder. And it killed me. Critted. I bet the crit mattered. I had 14 health. You think it mattered? I'm a Goodra, remind you. To just mind you, I'm a Goodra. And I resist it. I wonder. I guess we'll never know. Oop, that's not what I meant to do. Right, you should be chilling for now, Basque Legion. That's a Rapidash. That's a Pikachu. I don't believe I actually have caught a Pikachu. Oh, ow. Oh, shit, a Raichu. I caught it unawares. It's just a 1v1? It is just a 1v1. That's convenient. Alright. Agile Bulldoze. That should allow me to move twice in a row, I think. Oh, that almost killed it. Just caught unawares and too stunned to move. No way Thunderfang kills. Oh, that was a risky ass play. Thunderbolt, I could take one. Oh, I could take two actually. Look at that. Alright, and now we're gonna use a Great Ball. One hop, caught. Never misses. J. Cole style. Literally never. I'm telling you, man, never misses. Scyther. I've been caught Scyther. I have both of its evolutions. Fuck out of here, Scyther. I'm trying to pick up these shards. Another Scizor. Huh. I really am surprised that Scizor is in the game. That confuses me. Oh, I got a Comet shard? That's... how much are those worth? Espeon and Walrein. I don't have an Espeon. Realized that I sent out an Arcanine against the Walrein. It's not looking too hot for me anyway, to be honest. Does Strong Style Raging Fury kill? Probably. Oh, this is a 1v3 that I'm in right now. Alright, I'm just gonna go for a regular ass Raging Fury and see what it does. Oh, it missed. That's great. Scizor's looking around, Walrein's looking around, and Espeon's gonna kill me. Yeah. Oh, it has Double Edge. So does everything else in the game. You're not special, Espeon. Alright, I think maybe I'll X-Scizor it. With Toxicroak. Actually, does Espeon have good physical or special defense? Is it physical defense? I think it's physical. Espeon. No, it's special defense is good. So I'll go for Bascule Legion Shadow Ball. That's a good play, to be honest. Alright, we're gonna go for a regular ass Shadow Ball and see how much it does. Shadow Ball, cool animation. Oh, it O-code. Well, you hate to see it. Alright, we gotta run. Walrein, don't attack. It loses liquidation. That's not gonna do much. And we're gonna run. Green shard, grit gravel. We're gonna use the grit gravel. Another comet shard. Oh my god, I'm gonna make so much money. Alright, let's grab this grit gravel. We're gonna use this. Use that on your special defense, or I could use that on your attack. We're gonna do that. Ooh, I actually have Grit Dust as well. Alright, I need this Scizor to kindly fuck off. Ooh, is that a nugget? Hold up. Got a nugget. It's a large nugget. Alright, we need to do a bit of reviving. Revive Arcanine. And some healing. Alright, we're pretty solid now. I gotta think about what I'm seeing a lot of right now. It's not balance typing. I guess I just gotta go as I go. I wanna encounter a Bastiodon. Ooh! I just got hit with a flamethrower. What was that even from? Was that like another Rapidash that spawned when I wasn't looking? Kind of just hit me from behind. Hey, yo. Sylveo and Pikachu. What is that? That's another Scizor. I use these distortions more for the items than I use them for the Pokemon. The items are so useful. Spectre already hit level 61. That's cool. I think I'm gonna grab a spoiled Apricorn and make use of that next time I encounter a Pokemon that I would like to pick up. What is this? A Linking Cord. That's the first one of those that I've seen. Okay, those are Pokemon that I already have in the decks. Although catching an Electivire would be nice. Oh, that just didn't work at all. Okay, that's good to know. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I need to sneak so I can heal. Okay. We're all healed up. What just got mad at me? I didn't even see it. Oh, a Scyther. Okay. No more items spawning. I'm not seeing anything on the ground. Not seeing anything. Oh, and that's the end of the distortion. Okay, that was pretty successful. We got a lot of good items. Now, I'm gonna be smart about this, unlike I usually am, and we're gonna go back to the camp and put the important things away after we're done being targeted by this Pokemon, of course. That is an Alphys lineup that I just saw. That's pretty funny. Oh, whoops. Jeez. Jesus Christ. The freaking alpha Pokemon roaring at you and knocking you off your ride Pokemon is so annoying. What is targeting me? Like, what game? There's nothing targeting me. Thank you. Alright. Let's head back to camp. How long have we been going? An hour, 20 minutes? Nice. Alright, we're gonna do a just a little while type rest. And we're gonna do some item organization. Stuff that we shouldn't have in here so we don't lose it. Linking cord, a nugget. Citrus berries I can keep on me, I guess. Crunchy salt, stardust. Crafting materials I'll keep on me. Some of these are important. Organized satchel. Alright, how much space do we have? We have 10 empty slots. That's pretty good. That's good enough for now. And it will be 11 once I use up that citrus berry for something. In the bando I had a starving. Okay, we're gonna just use my boy Sneasler for, I guess I should say my girl Sneasler for this one. Alright, Sneasler, good shit. Let's hop back on Weirdeer and do some more exploration. I'm gonna try to find more spots that I have not yet been to. Which there seem to not be very many of. Trying to avoid the objective as much as possible so I could do as much exploring as possible. I'm also gonna collect these so I can get Sky Tumblestone so I can have more wing balls. We seem to be doing fine on every other kind of ball, so I'm not gonna even worry about it right now. We just seem to run through the wing balls faster than anything else, which makes sense because my aim with them is dog shit. Can I jump down here, or will I literally die? Oh. I thought it was a hole. Like, without anything there. It's not a hole without anything there. There's something there. That's a Ghastly. We already have Ghastlies. I'm gonna just skip on past the Ghastly. Is that a Mischievous? That is a Mischievous. I need Mischievous. So we're gonna try to grab one of our wing balls and catch the Mischievous with it. If the Ghastly would kindly fuck off. Okay, the Ghastly will not kindly fuck off. So we're gonna kill it first. Alright, Basque Legion, we're just gonna use a strong style Shadow Ball and call it a day. Oh, we don't even need to do that. We're gonna use a regular Shadow Ball and call it a day. It is a level 21 Ghastly. Alright, now we're gonna catch ourselves a Mischievous. Need it to turn around first. What do you mean? I would like a Mischievous so I could unlock those last hairstyles. Does it just disappear entirely? Because if so, I need to just battle one so I can catch it. Another Bergmite would be nice. Don't need another Haunter. I want to catch Bergmite so I can have a large Avalug. I think that would be cool. Alright, this is a what seems to be a pretty large area. So I'm just going to go to where it seems that there is a Mischievous waiting for me to catch. Ooh, there's a Zorua. I'd love to catch that. Alright, backstrike on the Mischievous. That's what we like to see. Caught the Mischievous, and there's that Zorua. I really want to catch this Zorua. You might be added to the team, actually. Probably will. Replacement of Toxicroak. It's either gonna be you or Avalug. Probably you for better type balance. Let's go, we caught it. It's only level 27. Maybe I'll see if I can catch like an alpha. Wait, what the hell? Another one just spawned right away. It's level 26. It's not much better. It's actually worse. It's only the gang that's important. Hello, Bergmite. Goodbye, Bergmite. Oh, so these... Oh, those holes in the ground are all connected through a system of ice tunnels. That's cool. I like that because these ice tunnels look freaking sick as hell. I want to explore the entirety of this cave system. What is this? This looks like it could be where you evolve a Glaceon, but it's not. A rock covered with ice touching it can make you freeze. Maybe that is to get a Glaceon. Is Glaceon an ice stone in this game, or is it not?
No, there's an ice rock and a grassy rock.
Yeah, I thought so. I just found the icy rock. I don't know where the mossy rock's at. Never saw that. Never in Quentrod.
I know where the icy rock is at.
Yeah, I just found the icy rock. Alright, thanks for the ride, Sneasler. Now we're gonna make a hard left, it seems. Well, not a hard left, but a left. We want to explore. Okay, Perugly. I don't believe I have Perugly. There was that alpha one once, but I did not catch it. I didn't even battle it. Yeah, it's a backstrike. Let's go. Call it the Perugly. Nice. It's a bunch of Perugly here. Anything new? Just Perugly and Bibarel? That's kind of boring. Ooh! An Alpha Sneasel. Alright, you are four times weak to Psychic. I don't have any Psychic moves, though. But I could temporarily give Basky Legion Zen Headbutt. But I would also probably one-shot you, which is not a good idea. So you're also weak to Ground. I have Arcanine for that. So I'm going to bring out Arcanine. You're also weak to flying, but I don't have any of that. Oh, I'm an idiot. I was just scrolling through my items like I was going to find Arcanine. Whoops. Alright. Okay, well, that didn't work. Alright, Sneasel. Oh, that didn't count. Come on, that's bullcrap. What level are you? 61. Okay. Swords Dance. That's a bit intimidating. Let's use an Agile Bulldoze. See how much it does, because I mean, not super bulky. Less than half. Close combat, that's gonna kill. Damn, that's annoying. Okay. What is that noise? Hello?
What?
What is that noise that you keep making?
Order bonus.
You should stop.
Okay.
Thanks, appreciate it. Freeze? Oh! That killed? I mean, we already have Sneasel, but I didn't think that was gonna kill. Okay, small EXP candy. It's gonna do nothing, so I guess we'll just get Toxicroak closer to level 55. And then Grit Dust. That's gonna go for Spectre's... Not Spectre's HP. It's gonna go for something else. Hatchet's Defense. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, let's revive our boy Arcanine. Let's use our last feather ball on this guy. Hiya! Caught. Oh, what? What the heck? We have a request over here. Do you happen to be... When is Craig ever gonna show up? Is this for a camp? Because that'd be nice. Yep, another base camp. Okay. I have to find Craig. I don't know if I necessarily would like to be looking for Craig, but I'll do it, because I'm a good guy. Ooh, pep-up plant. I can make one of my potions a super potion now. Right. Pop pods. Actually, these are useless. They're just for scatterbangs, and I hate scatterbangs. Discard. Alright. Spectre. This is, actually, let's have Hatchet do this while you get that. We've unlocked a cave. Secret Hollow. Is this it? It just has Tumblestone in it. And a Wisp. That's it. That's so weird. I just found a cave that just leads to a complete dead end that just has tumblestones and a wisp in it. It's kind of cryptic. That is a large waterfall. Damn shame that Basque Legion can't go up waterfalls. Oh, speaking of Basque Legion, there's Basculins in here. I guess there's a bunch of places where you can find Basculin. Find it here, you could find it in the place that we found it, and then you could find it in one of the other places. Probably a lot easier to catch them from land when it's an option. Oh, I found Craig. I like how far past the land you could go jumping out of the water with Basque Legion. It's cold as a cub chew snot out here. How do these Pearl Clan people stand it? Boy, do I owe you one for finding Craig for me. Now we can finally get things set up. Thank you, Construction Corps members Bryce and Craig. Was that your name? Bryce? Yes. Newest base camp. Look at that. That's wonderful. Goodness, I don't know how the Pokemon living in this frigid place find the energy to dash about as they do. They have a nice layer of insulating fat, perhaps? There must be some trick to it. Maybe. We'll do a bit of a quick rest just to restore our PP. Do I have anything that I could get rid of? Anything? Yeah, I have a few things I can get rid of. And by a few, I mean like one thing. Just one berry. Yeah, okay. What do you want, Bryce? It's so cold, I can't even feel my fingers. I can't work like this. I just want to earn my way up through the ranks. But to do that, I've got to at least warm myself up enough to feel my fingers. Do you think you can bring me a Pokemon that's good at manipulating flames? It could keep our fire roaring for me. Okay, yeah, I have fire types. A few. Oh, you know what would be fun if I gave it the, if I gave him the shiny Ponyta. Am I sure I want to give up this Pokemon? Maybe not. Maybe not the shiny Ponyta.
Yeah.
Here, maybe take sure, a Hisuian Growlithe. Yeah, take a Growlithe. You're welcome, Bryce. He's falling asleep standing up. You are old and decrepit. Oh no, I wasn't sleeping, I swear. I got a full restore. Oh, I got full restores. I didn't even know those were in the game. Nice. That is huge and a large EXP candy. We will use that on Hatchet. Yeah, Hatchet is now level 60. Let's go. The gap is probably pretty large now in the team, not including Goodra, obviously. We got level 54, level 54, level 55, level 60, and level 61. Yeah, that is a pretty big gap, a 5-level gap. Out of nowhere. Okay, let's venture up this mountain. Palm. Damn, there really just be nothing interesting in some spots. Is that another Apalm or is that a Gligar? I think it's a Gligar. That's a Gligar. Nice. That's a pep up plant. Those are useful. Another Gligar. Nothing interesting in this part, okay. We'll go back to where we just were then. Come on, Weird, do you remember the days where we cheated up the mountains that we were only supposed to get with Sneasler? You got this. There we go. There we go. Good job, Weird Deer. Back to our old cheating ways. Love to see it. Really do. What is this place? It's like a temple or something. It's a Chingling. Ooh, a Rufflet. Hello, Rufflet. Get in the ball. Thanks. Stay in the ball? Oh, thanks. That worked a lot easier than I thought it would. It's a Chimecho. Oh, it's an Alpha Chimecho. Ow! I don't need the smoke, man. I'm just trying to farm some materials, dude. Dude, bro, guy, man. There's Basculin over here, too. A bunch. Huh. Guess there are some easier ways to get Basculin than the way that we got it, which is nice. Hopefully it's possible for outbreaks of any Pokemon, because if it's not possible for some Pokemon to have outbreaks, that would be annoying, and shiny hunting would be very annoying for those Pokemon in particular. That's an Abra. I don't care. You can teleport away all you want, Abra. Those are Kadabra. Do you teleport away or do you get aggressive? Because if you don't teleport away, I would love to get a shot at catching one of you. Ooh, I'm real close up right now. Caught one. Caught two. There's no way that one doesn't catch. Yep. Look at that. It's two easy Kadabras. Damn, this place. All of the freaking zones in this game extend to, like, such. They're like borderline limitless. It's so good. The level design is incredible in this game. That is a large Bronzong. Hello. Please don't kill me. Would appreciate if you did not kill me. That's another Kadabra. That's another Rufflet. I need Sky Tumblestone more than any other Tumblestone, so I will take some of that any day of the week. There's more right here. Let's see what's over here. What is this little area for? Is it just a pointless rock? Interesting. Excuse is a funny cry. I kind of like it, though. I love this game, bro. I don't even think I'm going to get to the Avalug today. I'm not going to lie. What is this over here? I feel like this would be story progression, but it's not my next story objective. This temple? I feel like it's kind of weird that I can access this temple before progressing in the story. It feels like this could be something important later on. Huh. Let me collect this wisp real quick. I bet there's a wisp behind here too, so I'm gonna get that before I forget. Oh, I can't even go behind here. I take it back. Take it all back. Okay. The only ones who may enter Snowpoint Temple are those of the Pearl Clan and Sabi of the Diamond Clan for some reason. Okay. Guess they did block me off from there. I can access it almost. I need to look up how some Pokemon evolve. Like, how does Sneasel evolve? How does Rufflet evolve? Alright, I think it might be time to make some story progress. Ooh, wait a minute. Straight ahead, the way that I'm currently facing is some undiscovered places. So we're gonna hop on the homeboy Sneasler. Homegirl Sneasler. I keep calling Sneasler a boy. My bad. Sneasler is canonically a female. That is my bad, geez. That's not fall damage, right? I was gonna say, if that was fall damage, that'd be annoying. These are tents. This is all the Pearl Clan settlement. Why? Bro, I would be miserable living here. It's so cold. I am gonna skip some of the non-blue Tumblestones, because I am pretty loaded on Tumblestone right now. Yeah, I have 276 gray and 411 red. I really don't need it right now. Who are y'all? Who me? Even the Pearl Clan might start moving to new areas if our clan gets bigger.
only the founders of our clan had met Almighty Sinnoh somewhere a bit safe or warm, I'm sure many of us could have lived longer. Wow, that's dark. So people of the Pearl Clan have died because they live here, and they live here because because Almighty Sinnoh was encountered here by the Pearl Clan. That sucks. Hey, Basque Legion, you want to go for a dip? Seems like some real cold water, but it's fun.
That whole time I wasn't talking, it was about 4 losses.
Damn. How did he beat it first try? Did he just, like, ridiculously overlevel? He was just ridiculously overleveled.
He had a level 81 Sylveon. Fairy's OP, and he was
a level... Well, what level is your team after grinding?
My lowest is 66, and my highest is 73.
Yeah, 81 is a bit higher than that. Quite a bit.
Yeah, he was higher than the highest level.
On the enemy? Oh, wow.
Yeah. He was, like, 9 levels higher, I think.
Also, I bet using agile style moves when it doesn't look like it changes it does change it, but just for future turns that you can't see in the 3-turn preview.
Yeah, that only works when the same Pokemon is in the battle. So if I know my Pokemon is going to die within the next 2 turns, I'm not agile.
Oh, well, yeah, I thought that was kind of like a given, though. Ooh, a bridge. Don't tell PewDiePie. Get it?
Yeah.
Did you get the joke?
That's
oh, what? Sneasler can climb everything except for a little block of ice. Are you kidding me?
Wait, what noble are you on after now?
The last one. Avalug.
Avalug?
Yeah. I'm in the ice area.
Say Avalug if you didn't know it was Avalug.
That's fair.
This is an alpha.
Hippopotas. Are you sure it's not Hippowdon?
Coins!
Ooh, what comes out of the rocks here? Bergmite comes out of the ores here. It's a large Bergmite. I'm gonna run from it anyway. It's crazy. Coins. I thought speed was gonna be useless in this game. Speed is incredibly useful
speed
in this game.
Speed is so good.
Speed is, like, actually, like, probably the most important stat in this game. I thought it was going to be the least important stat in this game. It is very much not the case. Oh, I keep pressing plus to switch instead of using the D-pad. Wisp. I do have to say, the range on where you can send out Pokemon to collect materials is very far.
Iron chunks. Yeah, just be kind. I found her chilling in the wild. A wild pony just jumped out.
That's crazy.
They're a little toxic, and just smacked it right in the face. Really smacked.
It's pretty rude. Don't you think?
Literally got hit right in the mouth. Wait, let me guess. Did you drop 4 nuggets? Did she drop 4 nuggets? That'd be crazy if she did. Bro, she dropped 4 nuggets. I'm literally cracked.
So research level 10, they get shiny charm odds?
Close to shiny charm odds.
Interesting. And there is also a charm to stack onto that.
Yeah, there's also a charm. I don't know how you get it.
And we don't know about how that stuff stacks with the outbreaks.
No, it does stack. I just don't remember the odds.
Oh, okay. Got it.
I sent you the video.
I will.
It is 18 minutes.
I'll watch it probably tomorrow, because after stream, I'm probably just going to go to bed, to be honest.
How long are you going
to
be streaming for, bud?
Probably another hour.
Damn.
Alright, I have officially gone through every and unlocked every single
little sub-area of the Alabaster Icelands, I think it is time to make some story progress. We've Alabama seen what's offered. So I guess it's time to continue. Ooh, let's collect some Tumblestone first. Lots of Bergmite. Maybe I should just catch these. Because the more I catch, I get better. Stop turning around, Bergmite. I'll kill you. Oh, I hate myself. I'm so bad at this video game. Maybe I'm just bad at video games.
Gumi! I find you.
There we go.
Oh, it's so slow. And small.
I'm just trying to catch Bergmites. I'm gonna start actually focusing on catching Pokemon that I want. Like, a bunch of Pokemon of ones that I want to hunt at some point. Okay, whatever. Now it's story progress time. Let's get it. Adamant.
Oh, that's Alpha Goodra.
Well, that was a real slog fighting through those miserable icy winds to reach this desolate bit of nowhere. Well done, us. This gentleman is Avalug's warden and my most honorable teacher, Garrick. So show some respect, Adamant. Let's begin with some proper instructions. I am Garrick. I serve as one of the Pearl Clan's wardens. And you must be Daniel, right? Of the Galaxy team. Answer me this, would you? On what grounds do you come here seeking to quell Lord Avalug? He is in a frenzy. That leads to my next question. What is wrong with him being frenzied? It could trouble others.
Everything.
Then I have another question. Setting aside any orders, what is it your heart tells you to do to quell his frenzy?
No orders. He's in a frenzy.
Our mighty lord of the tundra, Avalok, has done nothing to trouble any person or Pokemon.
But he could.
Sir, please try to keep your cool. For now, indeed, Avalug's causing no trouble. But aren't we also duty-bound to free our people from living in fear that such a colossal Pokemon might begin to wreak havoc at any moment? We are. There's certainly some logic to that. But if that is what you hope to accomplish, then we must judge whether this child is up to the task. Who cares about the grandstanding? Let's get to battling. Let's start. Well, if you specialize in ice types, you're rolled. I have a fucking level 61 Typhlosion, bro. My musculature is as hard as and unyielding as ice. You think you can break through? I'm pretty sure if you drop ice from like 3 feet, it'll shatter. Starting with a Glalie, you idiot. Alright, Spectre, I guess we're just gonna wipe him. Oh, he has a Glalie and a Frostlass. Frostlass is much scarier, so we're gonna go for the Frostlass first. We're gonna go for an Agile Infernal Parade, because it's only level 24. Glalie's Ice Shard. It did nothing. We eat those. Oh, it double hit me, and he used Crunch, and that did actually a lot of damage. That is a bit scary, I must say. Agile Flamethrower, does that kill? I doubt it. I think I will go for a regular Flamethrower. Okay, yeah, that O-code. Nice. Oh, that was it. It was just those two. Okay. Outstanding. I'm as tough as an iceberg, but you smashed me through and through. Hey, yo. Pause. I suppose you all can get on with it now. This one's all right. Thank you, sir. Some may still have their doubts about a stranger like Daniel, but I'll vouch for him. Thanks, Arita. You're a little bitch. And if you insist on quelling Avalug's frenzy, You'll want to claim some of that eternal ice he likes and bring it to my lord's seat. Good luck. Eternal ice? Eternal ice, is it? For that, you'll have to be able to fly, which means you need braviary. Long story short, you've got to seek out a young lady named Sabi. Tell the long story long. You're not saving any time if we waste it puzzling out what you mean. Isn't Avalug one of the Pearl Clan's lords? Seems a bit odd for me to do the talking. But fine. Listen up. This Eternal Ice stuff can be found atop Avalug's legacy here. But to get there, you'll need my clan's help. Not even Sneasler can climb this service, let alone a person like you or me. You're gonna have to approach by air with Braviary's help. Garrick once managed to climb nearly to the top of Avalug's legacy. I'll have you know. He says he made it to within 6 feet of the top. Might makes right, or at least height. Shut up. And about Sabi, how do I put this? Even when she's not flying with Braviary, she's got her head in the clouds. Well, you'll understand once you meet her. Head towards Snowpoint Temple, and you'll probably come across her sooner or later. I've already been there. What? Sabi? Oh, she's here. That's convenient.
She is small.
Oh, she is very small. My clairvoyance told me that I'd lead you on a chase. Think you can reach me? I see what you mean about Sabi, but why would she be up there? Seems you better focus on pursuing Warden Sabi and let me focus on my workout while I still can. So I just have to get up there? Just to find a way up. Not gonna lie, this doesn't seem like too much of a crazy challenge. If I just use Weird Ear. Yeah, that was not that hard. Hello, my name is Sabi. Nice to meet you, Daniel. Pleasure's all mine. I've heard about you. You're super talented, right? I bet you're gonna be fun to play with. What the hell does that mean? You're not a Rezu. I know why you're here, too. You want Braviary's help so you can quell Avalug's frenzy, don't you? Well, you'll get it. If you catch me first. Let's go, Braviary. Wow. Just mad because you know when Braviary's cooler. Now where is this broad? Oh, what the hell? Alright, let's go, Weird Ear. Bitch is in absolutely Guam. I do like that you don't have to hold the stick forward to get moving with Weird Ear. Yeah, and it just moves, and then you can just steer it. Very convenient.
Do a bit of bing moving. Bing chilling.
Daniel, that's me. You made it all the way up here in this cold. But the question is, did you catch me or did I let myself get caught? Can I just battle you or something? Ooh, and one more thing. Am I even really clairvoyant? I don't... No idea. How would I know?
Clairvoyant?
No one but me could really know, right? Anyway, the challenge continues. The next stop of our merry chase is Snowpoint Temple. But the real question here is, am I really having fun playing with you or am I bored? Let's go, Braviary. It sounds like you're having fun.
You just went to the fucking temple, you stinky broad. Jesus Christ.
You been in that temple?
Yes, I went there already.
What's in it?
I couldn't enter it, so I don't know.
Just cool stuff in it.
Good to know.
Do Would you bet that there is stuff in the temple?
I bet there is. Is there a Feraligator in there?
Maybe. I'm not gonna spoil
it. Let's go for alligator in the game.
I didn't say that.
If it's not there, you're gonna be letting down one of your close friends. Do you want?
I just said that. I'm not
gonna no, you
it.
Said. You said. Yep.
Did I?
Yep.
Well, maybe there's a problem. I won't say anything. I definitely didn't see one, nor did I catch it, and almost sent one to the group chat. But I was like, no, this is. No, I didn't. That didn't.
Yeah, I know there's not a Feraligator in the game. There should be a Hisuian Feraligator in the game.
I'm telling you, man. The next game, bro. Magearna got Snap. Typhlosion got Arceus.
Magearna? You want to try again?
I said Magearna, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
Anyway, do I get to enter the temple now?
Yes.
Oh, sick.
You should get off of Sneasler.
I am off of Sneasler. Hi again, Daniel. It's nice having someone new out here to play with. Safety in numbers or something like that. Anyway, here's Snowpoint Temple. I've opened the front door for you. Just a little more
That's
chasing
crazy.
Left for you to do. But the real question here is, am I really having fun with you or am I bored? I'm gonna kill this bitch. I'm gonna kill her. I heard what Warden Zabi said. If you have Warden Zabi's approval to enter, then by all means do so. But be warned, those who cannot solve the temple's puzzles won't get very far within. I've heard that the trick is to pay attention to which way the stone statues are looking. Interesting. Come to think of it, I believe the statues have some sort of patterns in their chest, too. Thanks for the information, man. So this is going full Breath of the Wild mode.
That's big thing. Big fast forward fast.
A temple with a puzzle in it. Ooh, the inside of this temple looks sick. Oh, these are Reggie's.
Yes.
Reggie statues. What are these statues? We have a rock pattern, an ice pattern,
steel?
A steel pattern.
Steel.
Wait, what's this one? Another steel one. Wait, there's two steel ones? Is there two of each? There's two of each. Okay. They could have put a dragon and an electric, but they didn't. Fuck you, Bronzong. Eat my balls.
Whoa. You should go.
Sorry, I was busy murdering Bronzong. Do I have to do any battling? Because if so, I have some healing to do. Sure, I'll use it on your HP. Why not? Another Bronzong. Like, this is... Isn't this the same one? The same thing that was in the Reggie Drago, Reggie Alecki temple?
Yes.
That's cool.
And Rock, Steel, Ice.
No, the Rock, Steel, Ice one didn't have the two. They didn't have two heads. No, they didn't. They didn't have two heads. No, they didn't. No, they didn't. Go get on Sword and Shield right now and prove it to me.
I'm not checking. I know they did.
No, because I know they didn't.
I know.
Oh, I can't even use my ride Pokemon in here. Should I be descending or not? Because I'm descending.
No.
Oh, I can't be descending.
You should go descend anyway.
I can't.
You should see what's on the wall.
Hold on, let me use my Hyper Potion and heal up my...
What pattern was on that wall?
Regigigas' face.
I wonder what that means.
Something to do with Regigigas is my guess.
I think you're wrong.
Why would that be wrong? Is it has something to do with the patterns on their chests and the direction that they're facing. This would be a lot easier with Weirdeer, and by a lot easier I just mean more efficient.
Weirdeer.
Interesting.
Weirdeer.
Doesn't seem like I can change any directions. They have arrows on them, which might mean something.
Oh, you're gonna wanna remember that the
So that was... Wait, hold on. That one's ice, this one's steel. So this one's rock? Yeah, rock, steel, ice. Do I have to do something with this then?
I gotta click on the wall.
Wither the statue's gaze. Which panel will you press first? Rock. Steel. Ice. Oh, okay. Nice. That worked.
I thought it would be useless to invest that speed set in Arcanine. It was not.
Investing speed is very useful. Ooh, a wisp. How many wisps do I have? I wonder. Let's see. 36. That's ice. Rock. Steel. Okay, ice, rock, steel. And it pointed this way. So ice, rock, steel. Rock. Ice. Ice, rock, steel, rock, ice. Ice. Rock. Steel. Rock. Ice. Nice.
Did you know that Dark Pulse can't miss in this game?
That's cool. Neither can Water Pulse. Maybe Pulse moves can't miss in this game. Alright, so there seems to be a hole in the wall again, so... Ooh, what's down here? Okay, this seems to be the start of this puzzle. Yeah, so it's... Steel. Ice. Rock. Steel, ice, rock. Ice. Steel, ice, rock, ice. Steel, ice, rock, ice, steel. Steel, ice, rock, ice, steel, rock. Steel, ice, rock, ice, steel, rock. Steel, ice, rock, ice, steel, rock. Let's go! I'm so smart and genius and sexy and cute. Ooh. Hello there. Wow. Oh, wow! Okay, that is an Alpha Gallade. Wasn't very ready for that. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, I think Spectre kind of mercs that thing. It's weak to Ghost. I just need it to get away and stop staring me down like that. It's kind of scaring me a little bit.
You know what? This is the one.
You're feeling confident?
I'm confident this is the fight.
Okay, an Alpha Gallade. That came out of nowhere.
If I just get lucky with some misses and some status conditions, I win.
Yeah, but that's asking for a lot, to be honest.
Nope. I just need Nate to touch the controller.
You need Nate to touch the controller?
Yeah, Nate's ridiculously lucky with status conditions.
That's not true. It's that I'm ridiculously unlucky.
Well, then you touched my opponent's. I was about to say his name. My opponent's controller.
Your opponent doesn't have a controller, though, you dummy.
I was about to spoil who this person I'm fighting is.
That would have not been epic. I mean, you already did.
Who?
You said it's Cynthia's grandmother.
Nope.
Oh, the next person? The second part of the three parts? I'm so excited for that fight.
I'm not going to tell you anything. I'm just telling you it's a...
How did that notice me? Alright, I know what to do. I need to just get... Again, I need to get it in a bad position. Detroit urban survival training style.
I never said it was her.
Oh, that's true. That's true. You said she was in the game. You never said you were battling her. That's true. I just kind of assumed that. That is my bad.
You just kind of assumed
Alright. I think we go for just a regular Infernal Parade. And pray that it doesn't use an agile move. Don't use an agile move. Oh, on awareness. That's huge. I want to go for agile. But I also don't. Strong probably kills it. I'm going to go for another regular one. Oh, that's so lucky. Oh, that's so lucky. It resists fighting. But I think I just send a Pokeball at it. Just send a Great Ball. Come on. Oh,
no.
So cringe. I used Bulk Up. All right, I think I'm okay. Now is a good time to go for like an Agile Drain Punch. Ooh, okay. Was able to go twice. That's gonna kill. Damn it. All right, good try, Spectre.
I missed a 90 accuracy move that just lost me the game, didn't it?
Damn.
Oh. What was that? What was that call? Wait, why did she get to move 15 times in a row?
I'm gonna go for a Drain Punch with Toxicroak. I know a Psychic's gonna absolutely murk, but I'm gonna go for a Drain Punch. I doubt this kills. Okay, it doesn't kill. That's actually huge. And I get to move again. Alright, we're gonna go for a Great Ball again. I don't know. It should take another Drain Punch, but I don't want to risk it because that could have been a low roll. Come on. Oh, let's go! Okay, I didn't think it was gonna catch. Every time I see a triple hop, I get... I lose confidence.
I didn't use Strong. He didn't use Agile.
Sub 1 is not very happy. Okay, Grit Gravel, I'm just gonna use this on your... Not defenses, that's a waste. Hatchet. Your speed. Yes, okay. EXP Candy Large, I'm using it on Spectre, so I don't have to waste a revive. Now, Spectre is very high level ahead of Toxicroak and Arcanine. It is 7 levels ahead of those two. Barely the case for Toxicroak, though. Okay, we caught that Alpha Gallade. That is nice. I must say. Ooh, Curlia, that's a new Pokemon. Okay. Is Curlia not going to turn around? Okay, it is. Oh, it knows. Ayasabe. Now when it turns around, I will be... Ooh. Turn around, I'm crouching. Specifically so you cannot see me. Level 29. Okay, you're pretty low level. This shouldn't be too bad. Hiya! Okay, that should be caught. Yep, okay. I have a question for you, because I thought about this, and I think it's a pretty easy answer for me. Do you prefer skulking around and being stealthy to catch Pokemon, or going into their faces and getting into battles to catch them?
Being stealthy?
Yeah, me too. One of the coolest things I've ever done, well, it felt cool. It wasn't actually impressive, it just felt cool and looked cool. I was sneaking around, I think it was like a Luxio or something. But it was too far away for me to get it with a heavy ball so I could catch it. So I waited for it to turn around. And I dodged towards it and then used the heavy ball, which felt very cool. Nice. I don't think I clipped it, unfortunately, but it's somewhere in the VODs. I guess I've been caught, so we're nearly done. That's no fun. Hey, remember my clairvoyance? It showed me something else. I saw you flying with Braviary. Do you think that'll come to pass?
Come on,
I'll make
bro.
Sure it does. Well, however the future turns out, flying with Braviary is not easy. If you really want to be able to fly high in the sky, prove to me you're strong enough. Am I battling her? Gonna take us on? Yep. I guess Spectre's just carrying. Spectre, a.k.a. Mr. Hard Carry. That's what I said when we were fighting the Rapidash when Spectre was level 11. Oh my god. Rhyperior, Magmortar, and Electivire. By all three of them, do you mean at the same time?
Yes, and she controls one of them, the other two are wild.
Oh, of course she controls the Rhyperior when I'm using a fucking Typhlosion.
Just kill the Rhyperior first. Simple.
But with what?
I don't know.
Do I drain punch it? Like, how much is that gonna do?
Nothing. What level is it?
It's level 50, oh. I'm level 62.
Yes, level.
It's physical defense, its base physical defense is like 130. Its base special defense is like 55. So I don't know if I go for Infernal Parade. Or... oh, I don't know.
Do Infernal Parade.
Drain Punch is super effective, though.
Don't do anything.
Let's look at Rhyperior. I think Nate got the game today. Base, yeah, I was exactly right. Base 130 defense and base 55 special defense. I'm just that good at the game that I just know shit, okay?
Do Infernal Parade, no style.
I have to think about it, though. It's physical defense is over double. Drain Punch do over double damage. Drain Punch is 150 power. And this would be 90. Nah, Infernal Parade is definitely the play. I'm gonna go... I could go for an Agile. And that'd be 120, and that would be about 70. I'm just gonna go for a regular Infernal Parade. And pray that it misses a move, and pray that I burn. Burn! Please burn! Oh, that did a lot of damage. Oh, it didn't burn! Oh no, my day is ruined! They're all gonna move like three times now. Okay, that's gonna be munched. Okay, come on, right here. You just miss a Stone Edge. Oh no. Oh. Oh, that's gonna kill. Yeah. I mean, hey, that did a lot of damage, that Infernal Parade. I guess I should have gone for a strong style one, though.
Daniel, I no longer think that this is the one.
Damn.
I'm on phase two with one Pokemon left. You don't get any heals.
Yeah, you've mentioned that.
Just immediate.
Agile close combat surely kills, right? 80 power close combat.
Oh, and I missed. Of course I missed.
And I get to go twice before Rhyperior moves, so I'm just gonna go for close combat.
I'm gonna hit that watch, I'm gonna crit, I'm gonna die. Oh, he lives on 17 HP.
Okay, it did kill. Thank God. Flamethrower is gonna hurt.
I missed that one too. I missed twice in a row.
Thunder Wave, okay, that's not that big of a deal.
It hits the AD accuracy move.
Bro, low-key, if there's ever an option, like, if this becomes, like, an alternative to the main series, and we get the choice, would you rather have... okay, they just each went twice. Okay, and I'm dead. Flamethrower, Thunder Punch, Flamethrower, Thunder Punch. Anyway. And we get, like, an option after a few games to just transfer everything to Legends or transfer everything to main series, I might even pick Legends. This battle system is so much... I wouldn't say so much better, but I like it more. I want this battle system with abilities and everything. I want strong style and agile style in the main series. They're never going to do that, but that is essentially what I want. Arcanine, you are super effective on both of these Pokemon. And Magmortar is not very threatening to you, so we are going to attack the Electivire with a Bulldoze. We'll do Agile Bulldoze. It's only level 30. Oh, barely lived. That's annoying. Please don't tell me you have Aura Sphere. Poison gas. Okay, it's just going to poison me. I went for a Thunder Punch. We took that pretty good. Oh, and I got Parrot. Great. Instead of the poison. Love to see it. Oh, and it's just moving again. Okay. Yeah, I think we'll go for a Bulldoze. Just a regular Bulldoze to not waste PP. What the hell is happening? Are those birds? And family members that I hear in the background? I heard, like, rapid chirping. Alright. Strong style Rock Slide easily kills. Good job, Arcanine. Oh, look at that. Toxicroak leveled up. Oh, you caught us and you beat us. You've won all our games so far, but Braviary still wants to get to know you even better. Up to the roof we go. Are you not going to heal my Pokemon? That's kind of fucked up. You good? You good there?
I'm gonna march on over to Pokemon Company headquarters and slit the throat of whoever.
Whoa. Don't you think that is a tad extreme?
No. Whoever made...
I remember you texted me last night. You're saying, this is so hard, but I'm not raging. It's fun. I recall you saying something along those lines.
I did say that. It's been too long, though, man.
That's the point. When it's that long, do you know how good it's going to feel when you beat it?
It's 3 days of the same battle.
Hatchet, you are a gorgeous beast, and I really hope that you end up getting to be transferred. If not, you will carry all of my Legends games from now on.
Never miss an Air Slash, though. But I can miss a 95 Action move, too.
Oh my god, Luxray used to miss, like, Ice Fangs and Thunder Fangs, like, clockwork. It was so ridiculous. Just missed them every,
yeah,
like,
I miss
three turns.
All the time.
One.
Don't you love when that happens?
Yeah, I love it so much.
I missed Stone Axe twice in a row.
Whoa, this place is sick. Can I just jump off? That would be pretty stupid, but I... Oh my god, I almost just did it on accident, but I totally could, and I would die. That'd be funny. Hey, Sobby. Grok, Grok!
15 times in a row. It gets
all right, Braviary, why not
die.
Test out Daniel's strength for yourself? Oh, I'm fighting the Braviary. Okay. I think Spectre can handle this. Get some redemption for getting pitted against a Rhyperior. Level 54, I'm pretty confident that a strong style Infernal Parade Okos. Let's go, Spectre. Yep, good job. Actually goated. I can't believe Braviary lost in one shot. But that's that. Thanks for playing with me. I guess I'll head home now. Bye. Hey. I was kidding. Play along with me on your flute. Braviary is pretty large. Bro, this fit is clean as hell. I love purple. Braviary opened his heart and learned well the sound of your playing. You're gonna give me the flying type plate? Yep. What time is it? It's 9:12. Oh, I could totally do Avalug for sure. Thanks, Zobby. Oh, hi, Adamin. Sure, having Daniel to fly around with should be fun for Braviary. Yeah, I'm glad. A world where people and Pokemon live and work together, huh? Tell me, why do you think the lightning that comes from the rift would cause the rift would cause these frenzies? Do you think this is Almighty Sinnoh's anger, or do you think this is a trial it's putting to us? If it's a trial, if we prove ourselves worthy and we quell the last noble, calm Avalug, then the rift really ought to close, right? Even if the one who seems to be clearing this trial is a newcomer like you, not one of us who've been living here in Hisui for ages now. Wait, hold on, I did not say that right. Who've been living in Hisui for ages now. How come you're playing all wise? I thought you weren't a big thinker, Adamin. Hush, Sobby. I can feel history on the move. And as far as I can see, the one ushering in this new era is you. So if I stick with you, someday I might get to meet Almighty Sinnoh myself. That question is, does listening to Adamant fascinate you? Or bore you to tears? Shut up, Sobby. Anyway, Daniel, it's time for you to go soar with Braviary. If you jump from way up here, Braviary can take you gliding just about anywhere. Don't forget about the eternal ice. That's why you need Braviary in the first place, right? Okay, let's get it. Fucking Braviary, that's cool. Avalug's legacy is down there. I don't get why it's called that. Now go get a feel for flying with Braviary. When you're done soaring the skies and want to land, just ask him to dive. Got it. You can now call Braviary and glide through the air with him. Honestly, this might be the final fit. This fit is so clean. Braviary can fly high up in the air. Okay, yep, got it. Got it.
Honestly, the strat right now is to just beat phase one and get a ton of EXP from that, and then just keep on going there.
Oh, this is cool. This Braviary shit is cool as hell.
You expect to glot to, like, fall super fast.
It does not fall very fast, and then you can dive if you want it to fall fast.
And, or you can just hop off.
That's true.
You know what? Press the plus button. You can just press A in the air.
Yeah.
Like when you jump off a cliff with Weirdo.
Or like when you are drowning in water and you want Basky Legion, or you're up against a cliff and you want Sneasler.
Yeah.
If I dive straight into the ground, do I get hurt? I doubt it.
If you dive straight down?
Yeah. With Braviary.
You do not get hurt.
I just did it. Calms itself down first. Picking up some crunchy salt. Alright, this seems to be the ice. Investigate. Let's see. Is this the ice that is spoken of? Oh, my arc phone is beeping. It hasn't done that in a while, actually. What the hell? Forgot that I had that thing. You obtained a piece of eternal ice. So I just took it off. Took a chunk off of that. Type of ice beloved by the Lord of the Tundra, Avalug. This ice is... That's actually pretty funny that it's called the Lord of the Tundra, because I'm pretty sure Nate's Avalug is named Tundra. Wow. This ice is said to be fragments of ancient Avalug that lived long ago. That is terrifying to think about. What the hell? This ice is said to be fragments of ancient Avalug that lived long ago? So these are just like fossils? These are his ancestors' bones? Wahahaha! At last, this summit is conquered. Oh, look at that. The boy Garrick finally made it up on his own. And I see you made it too. Flew down to this place and obtained the eternal ice, did you? What drives that burning zeal of yours, I wonder? You gave Garrick the eternal ice. I do have to respect the effort you've put in. I may still have my own doubts weighing on my mind, but I will make the necessary preparations so that you can face my lord, Avalug. Meet me at Ice Peak Arena. Got it, brother. Now don't try to repeat the wondrous feat you're about to see me perform. A tall leap like this can only be managed by highly toned bodies like mine. Humble brag. Till next we meet. Thanks for doing an animation for it, Game Freak. Alright, Ice Peak Arena. Let's get it. Oh, it's Volo. Hello, Volo. Why, if it isn't Daniel, what a pleasure finding a familiar face, or any face, in this far corner of the Alabaster Icelands. I came to bring Garrick an order of sword caps, and he was more than willing to have a chat about Avalug. What do you say? Interested in a bit of gossip? Absolutely. And why wouldn't you be? So Avalug, yes, the fifth of Hisui's nobles. That he is, and you know what? He's an absolute beast. I believe it. Well, yes, according to what I was told, not only does he barrage you with chunks of ice, he also fires off massive icicles, and he can cause sharp ice crystals to erupt from the ground below you. Doesn't that seem a bit too powerful to take on? No. What's more, apparently the Avalug of old could be up to 100 feet tall. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Doesn't that seem a bit too big to take on? Yeah! Oh, you'll be alright. You just have to eat some sword caps, then give your training your all. Nothing better for building muscle than that. Onward now, to the arena. What were sword caps for? Sword caps for making, like, the aux attacks. I don't know why they don't just call them X attacks. It's whatever. Yes, well, I did want to see that Avalon, but perhaps not at the cost of my life. So I suppose my freezing digits and I will be off. Goodbye, Volo. Oh, there's that Machamp again, the one that I failed to capture before. Should I try it again? Not now. So we are to quell Avalug as you wished. In the end, the strength of your feelings won out. Or maybe your real strength comes from the way that you walk among both people and Pokemon. Well, I suppose I'd better get to work making some bombs using that eternal ice. I've heard how they're made, and with the muscles like mine, it'll only be a moment's work. So we're crushing up his ancestors' bones and throwing them at him because they're his favorite food. He eats his ancestors' bones. If you truly wish to quell Avalug, then walk on. The path lies before you, but know that Avalug will hurl chunks of ice at you without relent. You need unrivaled dodging ability. I'm going! Alright, it is 4 times weak to steel, and it is 4 times weak to fighting. I do happen to have a Toxicroak. And a, my two highest level Pokemon are also... Oh my god!
Yeah. I told you it was big.
My two highest level Pokemon have fighting type moves. What the hell? Yeah, it's pretty big. Yeah, it's like the biggest Pokemon. Literally, that's like bigger than Eternatus. That's surely more than 65 feet, right? Why is it so large? I'm sorry, am I only allowed to stay on this little platform over here? That's a little annoying. How am I gonna get to it to throw the bombs at it?
Just go to the edge and the bomb will...
Oh, I was not paying close enough attention. Oh wow, he's just sniping me. This doesn't look like it's gonna be a very easy fight.
God.
Why is it so large? Oh my god.
Are you kidding, man? Missed it twice in a row again?
Alright, Spectre.
I missed Stone Axe twice.
Bro.
Again.
What the hell is this thing's size? Strong style drain punch. Let's do it.
3 times in a row! A 90 accuracy move.
Okay, that did a lot of damage. Not enough, though. That thing is fucking massive. Agile Earth Power? Ooh, that's gonna kill, isn't it? Oh, I ate that. What the hell?
A 90 accuracy move. I missed 3 times in a row.
I've missed Air Slash 5 times in a row.
This is ridiculous.
Alright, Hatchet. It's all on you, man. Close combat, let's get it.
I missed Crunch. You'll love to see that. And I just lost because I missed four moves.
It happens, man. It happens.
That's ridiculous. Dude, that is the most rigged crap I've seen in a Pokemon game ever.
How big is Avalug normally? Its height from foot to top is only 4'11", or something like that, Hisui and Avalug.
I caught a really small Avalug. Compared to that.
Most Avalugs would be small compared to this. Or did you mean compared to 4'11"?
No, compared to this.
Yeah, most Avalugs are small compared to this. This fight is sick. Holy shit. It's so large. It's so unexpectedly large.
That's...
Ooh, I'm gonna die. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. I almost perished.
I missed Raging Fury on the first turn.
Isn't that only 85 accuracy, though?
I don't care.
Oh, I died. That's ridiculous that I died. I dove into spikes that
and
were
I
sitting on
it
there.
Again?
Hardly. What did I lose? Oh, right.
I
you don't lose
Fury
things
again.
Here. Of course I'm going to restart
that
the battle.
That is dumb.
I ain't no biatch.
That's dumb. I wouldn't have gotten drowsy if, you know, it hit the first turn. That's going to use that.
Oh, ow, that hurt. Oh shit, this is rigged. This is rigged! What the fuck? It's like the fucking election! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Look underneath you, bro! Just roll dodge to the side!
Yeah, but it's not that easy! I don't have time.
Dodge into the other one. Dude, you suck. I missed Esper Wing.
What is Esper Wing?
It's a 90 accuracy move. It's Braviary's move. Bro, what is my luck?
Bad.
Dude, I better get like 5 shinies in a row.
I hate to break it to you. I don't know if that's gonna happen.
Nothing bad happened. Like, I didn't get touched. Like, it just took a long time.
Free health. Give me the health,
yep,
brother.
You get to hit rock slide. You get to hit rock slide. Did you get Giga Drain on that thing?
Yeah, on my Typhlosion. I don't trust this fucking Avalug one bit.
It needed to kill and it did. And he hits every... How many times? He has missed 2 moves in the past 3 days.
And ooh, fuck, fuck.
7.
What do you mean? Bro, I dodged to the side and it dodged into the move. Nope, I'm not restarting there. That's the same thing that happened with Arcanine, except I misclicked. I'm not restarting there.
Wow, you are such a loser.
I dodged to the side and it dodged the opposite direction into a move.
So?
Yeah. That happened with Arcanine, except it wasn't the same. There was an invisible wall that I didn't know was there, so I just didn't move.
You're bad.
But I'm not bad, bro.
The invisible wall isn't where the lava is. You're gonna roll.
No, it wasn't where the lava was. It wasn't where the lava was. It was behind.
Where the invisible walls
are. No, it's not. There are invisible walls behind the area where you fight, because obviously the area where you enter that area is open, and I didn't know where the wall started, so I dove to the side and hit an invisible wall, and I didn't end up moving anywhere.
What is that?
I have the clip. It's not the lava.
Cap.
I have it on video. It's not the lava. I'm restarting, because you're... Call me a bitch. I ain't no bitch. I'm not gonna get called a bitch by somebody whose middle name is Harold.
Damn, that's crazy that you just said that. Still can't get no frostbite and no bitter now.
Don't ever say it like that ever again.
Yep, use Moonblast. There's fairy types in this game. Not in DDFC. There's some.
Yes, they are, you dumbass.
Oh, yes, they are.
Yes, you are. You're very dumb, actually. Very dumb. Call me bad at the game saying there's no fairy types in DDSP, dumbass. We should kind of have this down to a science. We go for an agile drain punch. And that only allows it to move once. And then we get to move twice.
No. 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 Oh, I live. Dude, if I died there, I would be so angry. I like half my team.
Using this opportunity to heal up my boy. Okay.
Good level.
Mic off. Mic on.
Sorry about that. My mic just turned off. Ah! Oh, how'd that hit me? What do you mean? That was a good dodge. Oh, he's fucking... Sniper icicles are so annoying. Oh, I needed to look up. I was not paying any attention. Oh, I'm so about to die. This is so bad. I'm gonna die again. This fight is hard. What the hell? Oh, thank God. Whoa, 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 whoa! What? Okay, I was gonna say, it almost didn't let me initiate a battle with it. Okay. We know the drill, agile drain punch. And this is, like, guaranteed. It's gonna go for an earth power, we're gonna barely take it. Unless it crits, that would suck. Okay, didn't crit, and then we get to go twice. I'm just gonna get two drain punches. And get some health back, too. All that, and we have 2 PP left on the move.
You ready for Stone Axe to miss 5 times in a row? I sure am.
I'm literally not even going to throw anything at it for this phase, because I stop focusing, and then I miss, and if I get hit one more time, I die. Oh! I beat it. Jesus Christ. I got that. That was stressful. Oh, it's so large. Why is it so large? Oh, my heart is racing. That was easily the hardest boss fight out of all the Lord Pokemon.
Dude, Stone Axe.
The nobles. That Avalug is sick looking. Holy crap. Whew. How much tinier is it now that it's no longer frenzied? I received the icicle plate from Avalug. Thanks, Avalug. Oh, does it not approach me? I don't get to see how large it is now. That's kind of weird. Garrick, sir, you needn't look quite so downcast. But seeing mighty Avala quelled, and by such a slight child, a child that fell from the very sky. It's been a while since they brought that up, actually. Is this Daniel boy some kind of monster in disguise? Oh yeah, baby, I'm a beast. He's no monster. He's the one who risked his life without a second thought in order to quell our frenzied, suffering nobles. Daniel, Garrick cares for the Pearl Clan with all his heart and believes in Almighty Sinnoh just as deeply. So he has feared more than any of us that getting involved with the Diamond Clan and your galaxy team could cause our people to flag in their devotion to Almighty Sinnoh. But that will change. Arita? I know your fears will change once you see what I've seen. Daniel has much to teach us. He's shown us how we can overcome all manner of strife so long as our Pokemon are with us. He's made me want to help Glaceon realize greater strength as well, and to see my whole world grow broader. It seems you've already changed, Arita. I knew you could pull that off, Daniel. You quelled every last frenzied noble. Is that space-time rift going to start closing up now, or what? There's little way of knowing for sure, though the rift does seem perhaps a little smaller somehow. Let's hope so, anyway. Well, with any luck, things will settle down now. Although, even if the rift does start spitting out more of that strange lightning, we should still be alright as long as we've got Daniel. Indeed we should be. It's good to have him at our side. You know something, Arita? We may never agree on who's got it right about Almighty Sinnoh, but you Pearl Clan folk aren't all bad in my book. Look who's finally seen reason. Anyway, now that we've quelled the last noble, I say we pay grim old Commander Commodo a visit and see if he'll finally crack a smile for us. Wow. Look at that. Last noble. And very not even close to being done with this game. Doesn't seem to be something that is coming very soon, to be honest. I kind of want to try to get this Machamp again, I'm not going to lie. Catch this freaking Machamp so badly. Ooh, Grit Dust. Let's use that real quick. Grit Dust. HP! Okay, hello there, Machamp. It'd be nice if you turned around a tad. Oh, very nice of you. Appreciate it. I caught Machamp unawares. I think an agile flamethrower, maybe? Maybe a strong... No, not strong. I think agile Infernal Parade is the play. Try to get a burn. If I'm trying to get a burn, I might as well just do an agile flamethrower. More power. No burn, but it got caught unaware. Go for another agile flamethrower because why not? Kind of burning through the PP though. Burn? Let's go. Okay, we got the burn. That's huge. Fire punch. Why would you use fire punch? You have stone edge. Okay. So those flamethrowers were 90 power. So I can do something that's about double that. 75 times 2 times 1. So that's 75 times 3. Which is 225. That's too much. So maybe a regular Infernal Parade. That's 90. Times 2 is 180. Maybe just an Agile Infernal Parade is the play. Just to be safe. Because now it only gets to move once and then gets to move twice. Fire Punch again for some reason. Burn. Oh, the burn got healed that quickly. That's so annoying. Alright. Great ball. Figured the first one wouldn't work. I could use two in a row though. That's why I use the agile moves. Come on. Jesus Christ, this Machamp is not easy. Machamp Ruin Rage. Just keep using Fire Punch, please. Agile style. Fire Punch. Bless you. Keep using Fire Punch. Used two fire punches and it killed me because it got the enragement boost.
No
missed again. Oh, not again,
dude. This is ridiculous.
Arcanine, see if you can get an aux accuracy.
Bullied by RNG.
Make an aux accuracy.
No, that's a waste of a turn. I don't have that. I don't have turns to waste.
Well, if you spam agiles and you get like a two turn thing, then it's worth it. Oh, let's go. We caught the Machamp. Finally. Jesus Christ. That took forever. It's annoying that Spectre couldn't get any experience from that, but I guess it doesn't matter in the end because Spectre is the highest level on my team. Seems like the life I need is a little distant. I'm pretty sure I caught everything at least once that shows up here. So that's a lot of new Pokemon in the Pokedex, I believe. We're about to see. We're gonna make it over this ravine, this cavern. Looks to be so. Yep. Look at that. Caught 31 Pokemon. Yes, I would care to report my findings. A lot of new Pokemon. Let's see, we got Snorunt, Bergmite, Piloswine, Swinub, Machoke, Riolu, Elekid, Snover, Abomasnow, Blissey, Glalie, Scizor, Pikachu, Raichu, Mistrevis, Zorua, Perugly, Rufflet, Kadabra, Ralts, Kirlia, Gallade, and Machamp. Both Alpha Gallade and Machamp. That's cool. That's going to be a lot of money. $27,000. How many new Pokemon? 22. That's pretty good. Look at that. Time is it? It's 9:43. Alright, we'll get through this dialogue and then we'll end it there probably. First, I'm gonna talk to the baby girl herself. What's up, Arezu? I haven't talked to you yet this stream. I did actually catch you in Mischievous. So give me some new hairstyles, baby. You know, people are afraid of Mischievous because of how apparently it wails at night. But getting a good look at it like this really gives me some fresh perspective. Look at how it billows and sways and flows. Wait, that's it. That's what I'll do. Oh, I just thought up some charming hairstyles and an enchanting new palette of colors. All thanks to you and Mischievous here. Come by anytime and try out my new ideas for yourself. Gladly. We need new hairstyles. Please don't tell me these ones suck, too. No, that's not right either. Extra one. Oh, nice thing as always. Another wall here. Curlia.
You know what? You know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm just gonna go back to base camp and buy EXP candies.
Damn. You could do that.
I'm just gonna. I don't care what. I don't care what you call me. At least I didn't continue a noble battle.
That's fair. I didn't actually do it.
You
I restarted.
No, you did the Arcanine one though. So.
No, I didn't do the Arcanine.
Oh no, you didn't. No, you didn't.
That's I was going to, and then I misclicked. Alright, the next thing she wanted for more hairstyles was a Curlia, so I got extra hairstyles.
I've seen Zoroark use Bitter Malice 40 times. I've only used Bitter Malice in that fight.
What?
I got a Zoroark.
Is Bitter Malice right its special move?
Yeah.
It's a ghost type move, I'm assuming.
60 power. Turns into, it's pretty much Hex with a chance to freeze.
Oh, so it's the same thing as Infernal Parade with a chance for Frostbite instead of a chance to burn.
Yeah, it does more power or whatever for the status condition.
Yeah. Alright, let's see what new hairstyles you got. I gave you two whole requests worth of new Pokemon. Curlia and
Eugene,
Mischievous.
Nope. Eugene Cannonball.
Alright, let's see what you got now. Let's see what we got. Tied back, shorn, middle part, side part, modern bowl cut, side swept, fancy, curled, top knot, braids, and modern short. Oh my god, these are all terrible. Jesus Christ. What do I have to do to get good hairstyles in this fucking game? Oh my god. I mean, maybe this fancy one that's like big hair. No, that won't look good. I'm not even going to try to lie to myself. I'm trying to think if any of these will look good with the hat on. I think this one, not this one, the top knot might look good with a hat on. What new colors do we have? Turquoise, violet, clementine, peach pink. Honestly, ash brown is about as close to my hair color as it gets. Instead of yellow. Yeah, that's way closer to my hair color, that grayish brown. Like the modern short might look good with a hat. You know what? We'll just do this one and keep the hat on. It's gonna look terrible without the hat, but let's see how it looks with the hat. I'll wear the hat. Okay, let's see. Okay, that's not terrible, to be honest. That's an upgrade. I'll say that much. It is an upgrade. I'm gonna try the modern short. I want to see what that one's like. I can waste $1,500 on haircuts. I'll be fine. All right, we're gonna try modern short and see how that looks with the hat. Again, they look terrible without the hat, but. None of these hairstyles look good without the hats. I was hoping there would be a good hairstyle that I could just put a headband on for, but nope. Okay, this one might be the one, to be honest. It's not much like my hair, but it's the best looking hair.
I can just absolutely use legendaries in this fight. I'm just not going to.
That's fair.
Because that's so baby.
It's wrong is what it is. Should be illegal.
You know what else is wrong? Level 81 Sylveon.
That's true. How did he get the level 81 Sylveon? Did he catch it at level 81?
He caught an Eevee, evolved it into Sylveon, and just grinded with it.
I feel you,
like,
I feel
he
you.
He just halted all story progression to grind up his team.
Gotcha.
Before the story ended. Like, this is all post-game.
Interesting.
Mic off. Mic on.
Alright, sorry about that, chat. I know the mic on, mic off shit's probably a little annoying, but I like it because the voice is hot. I'll be back in like 5 minutes. Hold up. Alright, I am back. We're gonna do a bit of selling. How much of this? Okay, I'm gonna make. Yes, sir. Alright, that's cool, that's cool. I'm gonna buy some revives, actually. $15,000 for comet shards? I found two of those. Oh my god, I'm loaded. All these bands busting out my pants, slide with me. I'm just trying to flex. Oh my god. That's crazy. That can go over there. Let's organize that a bit. Alright, I can use that grit gravel of mine. Can I use that on here? Use that on your defenses, or I could use that on your defenses. Interesting. Actually, I can use that on your HP, can I? Oh no, I can't. Shit. Does this man have to sell to me? Mechanical cabinet? What What's a mechanical cabinet? $20,000? Do you know what this is? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hi.
Do you know what a what the mechanical cabinet is? Is it something for Rotom?
Yeah, I think that's the microwave.
It's $20,000. I'm good. Alright, how much money do I spend on inventory space? All of it? I have $70,000 right now. I'm loaded. Right, I'm gonna go give this guy his crunchy salt so I can increase the merchant's wares. I'm not reading this again. It's the same shit every time. Thanks for giving me the crunchy salt. Transfers of minerals great for making potent Pokemon lore. You gotta break it up with a hammer, then get chunks in a mortar and crunch them right up, grind them into a powder, mix that powder with another ingredient, and pack the mix together, and you'll get a crunchy cake that Pokemon love to munch on. I can send you back to a Detroit of failure since you know so kindly brought me this crunchy salt. Alright, you set them up with new heirs. You wanna know what happened between me and Troy? Well, that whelp made off with my dearest treasure. I'll never let him live it down. Oh, there's some beef here. There's a reason they're beefing. Choi left off with Tao Hua's greatest treasure.
No, I caught a Riolu. It's in the spot where you are. It's in that area. Oh, there's more. What?
Jubilee Village?
I didn't even know Riolu was here.
Yeah, I've been caught a Riolu. There's also a, what's it called? There's, an Alpha Lucario there.
I'm not surprised. I'm gonna rip his face off. Not literally, financially.
Alright, what do you have now? You got all these balls. You got, oh, now you have leaden balls and wing balls for not that expensive. You got hyper potions and super potions and max potions and full heals and revives. I will definitely be buying some revives. I'll be buying some hyper potions. Super potions, I'll buy like 6 of those. Hyper potions, I'll buy like 8 of those. I really don't have a need for max potions yet. Interesting. So now I can just buy these Pokeballs instead of crafting them. I feel like I have too many crafting materials to not craft them. Kind of a waste of money to buy them. So yeah, alright, I'm gonna... Do I just blow money on inventory space until I can anymore? When does satchel space cap in Pokemon Legends Arceus? Oh, wait, what? There's a request where you get to catch an Alolan Vulpix?
I don't know if you get to catch it.
But you get to find it.
Yeah. I think I have it ready. I just haven't done it yet.
Interesting. I wonder if you can catch it. It seems like a blessing at first, but you soon realize that he's teaching you. It seems like a blessing at first, but you'll soon realize that Baggin isn't teaching you how to expand your satchel out of the goodness of his heart. For each slot in your satchel, you'll need to pay Baggin a neat fee. That fee gets less and neat the more slots you get, and gets very expensive quickly. Each time you add a slot, Baggin's fee increases. The first slot starts at $100. There are 37 additional slots that can be added, which means maxing out your satchel will cost you a neat 4.2 million Poké Dollars.
Wow.
37 additional slots is a lot, though.
That is money.
Jesus Christ, it's a lot of money. $10,000. How much is the next one gonna be? Is the next one gonna be 15,000? I bet it's gonna be 15,000. 12,000. Now it's going up by 2,000. What else could I spend my money on that's valuable?
Not yet.
Nothing. I'm just blowing all my money on this stuff. I can only afford one more anyway. That's crazy. My satchel's just absolutely loaded right now. I literally can't afford it. I had $70,000. I now have a tenth of that. Alright, we're gonna talk to Komodo, and then we're gonna call it there. And that's gonna be it for today. Each of the Pokemon nobles became frenzied, and now each of them has been quelled. We still have no explanation for why this calamity befell us, but I'm glad to see it put to an end. And to think peace would be restored to Hisui by the hand of our mysterious Riftborn helper. When tomorrow dawns, it will dawn on a world restored to normalcy. At long last, we will be able to return to our normal lives. Go nourish yourself at the Wallflower and allow yourself a good long rest. Don't forget the Survey Corps' work is not over. It does not end until our people can live here in Hisui without fearing the Pokemon around us. That's crazy. Thanks for this nice sizable helping of potato mochi, Benny, old chum. Oh, and if there's anything else that you'd recommend, by all means, bring it out. Really? Anything else other than potato mochi, Laventon? You're really stretching your horizons out there. Having the nobles all quelled puts a grave threat to rest. Now it's time we focused on our survey work, though we still can't let our guard down around regular wild Pokemon, of course. I certainly had my reservations as to whether Avalug needed quelling, but if it means bringing calm to everyone, then I suppose we did the right thing. Yes, someone might have been under attack by some frenzied noble this very moment if Daniel hadn't come falling out of the sky to us. I still wonder, though, just what is the space-time rift anyway? And what will make it finally go? Wait, if the rift were to vanish, would that leave Daniel stranded here? I guess so. Well, our little team is certainly very practiced at investigating things by now. We'll look into the matter and find a solution, I've no doubt. And if we don't, you'll always have a home here in Jubilife Village, Daniel. Now then, tomorrow's soon upon us, and it'll be another hard day at work for the Survey Corps. Don't forget what we've got our sights on, nothing less than a completed Pokédex. That's right, we'll get it done, with Daniel in the lead and me as the valiant assistant. Oh, don't put yourself down like that, Akari. I just did all of the work. Oh, Laventon literally says that afterwards. Assistant? Come on now, Akari, don't sell yourself short. You're a full-fledged member of the Survey Corps, too. I called it. I'm a clairvoyant, it's not Sabi, it's me. Well, thanks for that, Professor. Then I guess I'd better eat my fill and get plenty of energy for another long day tomorrow. The next day. I think I have an apricorn harvest waiting, even though I have way too many apricorns. No such thing. I have so many apricots. Oh, what the hell? Bakoom! Explosion? The fuck? Disaster looming? What? Alright, chat. This... I think this is a great time to end stream. I'm not gonna lie. I think a big cliffhanger is a good way to end it. So we're gonna do just that. We're gonna save our game. 30 hours and 43 minutes in. We're gonna double save because I'm just nice like that. And tomorrow, we will see what happened outside. I hope you guys enjoyed. I had a very fun time again. I always stream way longer than I should. My school days start at 7 a.m. and I don't go to bed until 10:30. But that's going to be it for today's stream. I will catch you guys in the